All right, Popsy. I'm going to think of a special word, and you have to guess what it is.
Let's do it.
It starts with an F.
Will you grab me a Mel Yellow,
ball?
Please?
No.
Ball?
Stop in and see my Popsy at Terry's Floor.
It's a sign of success. A lot of realtors want your business. It's a sign to follow your dream. Home for sale, new kitchen, new
floor. Call Hometown Realty of Greenville at 639-2345. Because Hometown Realty of Greenville.
Welcome back to the Pioneers.
Coming in on
Also, Festival Coverage does not allow pets at any Pioneer home athletic events. We thank you in advance for your cooperation with these policies, and we hope you enjoy your visit to Tuscan College and Pioneer Theater. Tuscan Athletics wish to say thank you to its corporate sponsors for their support of Pioneers Athletics. Advanced Cleaning and Restoration, Applebee's, Artistic Printers, Babcock Home Furniture and More, Bachman Bernard Chevy Buick GMC, Bojangles, Consumer Credit Union, and Corley's Pharmacy. Fans, you can listen to today's game on the Pioneer Sports Network. Listen to the excitement of Pioneer football on Sports Radio 1450 WSMG. Today's game is also being streamed worldwide on the internet at TusculumPioneers.com. An in-stadium broadcast may also be heard on 90.9 FM. Coverage is ongoing with the Pioneer pregame show. Then stay tuned as the voice of the Pioneers, Brian Staten, along with Joe Bird, describe all the action from start to finish. Coverage concludes with the Pioneer postgame report, with recaps, highlights, and statistics. That's the Pioneer Sports Network on 1450 WSMG, 90.9 FM in stadium and online at TusculumPioneers.com. Tusculum Athletics wishes to say thank you to its corporate sponsors for their support of the Pioneer, including Double D Tire and Battery Store, Eastman Credit Union, Fanatics 101, Gateway Ford Lincoln Mazda, Grand Rental of Greenville, Green County Express, and Greenville Lightning Power.
You ready?
Yeah, we're ready.
Attitude that we can give. They're willing to sacrifice their own safety for ours.
His lower body. Yeah, his lower body. He's got it.
Greenville Federal Bank. Member FDIC. Banking made
easy. So, keys to the game.
Have trouble keeping track of your medications and when you should have them refilled? At Corley's Pharmacy, we're here to help.
That's right, Jeff. We can now fill your medications on the same day each month. Your refill date will always stay the same so that it's easier for you to remember.
Yes, Alan. And if you don't remember, a member of our staff will call and remind you. We also offer free in-town delivery. At Corley's Pharmacy, we've been dispensing great service and friendly smiles since 1976.
We're the pharmacy that you've grown up with. Stop in and see us today at Corley's Pharmacy on Snaps Ferry Road.
Welcome back to the Pioneer Pregame Show. Tusculum College Football on the Pioneer Sports Network. Once again, Joe Bird and the voice of the Pioneers, Brian.
We welcome you back into the Pioneer Kickoff Show tonight. It's Tusculum versus Shorter. Yes, night football here at Pioneer Field. Jerry Odom, a product of Florida, a guy playing in the SEC, likes playing those night games and wants these guys to have that atmosphere, and they will have that really for the first month and a half of their schedule, playing later in the evening on Saturdays. A Tusculum Pioneer team taking on Shorter. Tusculum and Shorter both enter at 0-1, both teams losing last week. Tusculum to North Greenville University and Shorter falling to Mars Hill. It's time to take a look at our keys to the game as we welcome back in Joe Bird. Joe, last week what I think I like about what this Pioneer team has done, through the five games last year, they didn't even average double digits in offense. Last week they put up 33 points on a North Greenville team where early it didn't look like it. It almost looked as if they were just kind of settling in, a bunch of new faces, learning some new roles, and they're still learning, but we're learning guys like Shaq Harris at tight end, Alex Ogle at quarterback, Maxwell Joseph at running back, and Evan Gates at wide receiver, plus a couple of new offensive linemen. I think for the key to the offense is that offensive line, though, has to gel. It has to be very good tonight for the Pioneer offense to be good.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. The offensive line was the one place last week we saw that needed some improvement. But for me, the big keys for the game for Tusculum, finish the or start tonight the way they finished last week. starting the first quarter, everything started slow. Some things weren't coming together just because so many of these players had never actually played a snap of live football against an opponent. So it took them a little bit to get going. But once the Pioneers did get going, they just about took it to North Greenville.
Shorter's offense last week, led by B.J. McCoy on the ground, was 78 yards. But Tyler Pullum, a good game, 19 of 28, completing 68% of his passes, 244 yards against a decent Mars Hill defense. They were great from 20 to 20. It was once they got into the red zone, they could not finish, I think, for this Pioneer defense tonight. And I think he would tell you the very same. Jay Boyd has to have an All-American. He has to kind of live up to that billing. Last week he didn't do it. He would admit it to you. He admitted it to his coach after the game. Coach, I wasn't very good. I think Jay Boyd has to be good because they can't have those type of passing numbers against this Pioneer team, because North Greenville shredded the Pioneer secondary last week.
Well, and that's what you got to do. The main thing, if you talk about quarterback Tyler Pullman, Shorter has two main receiver threats. Joseph Ross and Lewis Hayes each had seven receptions. So that's 14 of those 19 catches. Those two guys, Ross the 101 yards, Hayes with 87. Pioneers drop back in coverage. Don't let those two guys beat you, and they should be able to contain the Hawks' passing game.
All right, special teams, no question here. You can sit there and deduce for yourself. You can say that Matt Gravely missed two field goals, but those are a 47 and a 41-yarder last week. Jose Esparza has got to put the ball through the uprights on an extra point. We have to be solid there, but it's not necessarily just Jose's part. They have to make sure they're lined up right on that line in order to protect him. It's funny what that ball does. It draws attention. When it snapped back to the holder, teams like to come after that football, and I think a little bit last week we didn't get lined up on the offensive line for extra points. I think that has to be a key special teams wise. Just make sure you're lined up properly.
Line up properly, block, and then you got to have that crisp, quick exchange from center to holder, and your kicker come through just in a quick motion, because you have very little time with those big guys crashing around the ends.
Just overall, here we are, the home opener. It's Tusculum, it's Shorter. You know, what do you want to see from this Pioneer team tonight?
I want to see an exciting game, electric football. Get people excited and want them to get people to come out here. This is a new era for Tusculum football. We've got a new look to the team uniform-wise. Get people excited. Some folks are outside having a good time. Get them in here to the stadium to have a good time.
It's the Orange Wave night. Look, Jerry Odom hung his hat as the defensive coordinator, associate head coach at Jacksonville, as one of the best defenses in the country. 20 interceptions in his last year there. They want to create some excitement defensively. I want to see that tonight. I want to see interceptions. I want to see returns. We saw D. Offord pick up a fumble and go the distance last week. I want to see some interceptions. I want to see Jay Boyd getting happy. I want to see this secondary getting happy today if, in fact, Tyler Pullum decides to go to the air like he did last week. We'll hear it from the horse's mouth, I guess you could say, Jerry Odom himself. What does this team need to do to be successful tonight against the Hawks of Shorter University? We'll have that interview when we return with the last word right after this. Tusculum and Shorter, this is the Pioneer Kickoff Show on the Pioneer Sports Network.
When you're ready to buy a new or used car, truck, or SUV,
about 10 till.
Deal.com.
support our student-athletes each and every season. To find out more about Pioneer Club membership, please see the back page of today's game program or contact Blake Cantrell, Director of Athletic Development, at 636-7331. Safety of players, coaches, and officials standing or sitting on the sidelines or at field level is prohibited. Fans are asked to sit or stand in the seating areas only. Only media and staff are allowed on the field or sidelines during the game and must have proper credentials. We thank you in advance for your cooperation.
Homeownership is the foundation of the American dream. It is a significant milestone in your life and is an important financial investment. Realty Executives has years of experience in helping homebuyers and investors.
I've still got to run your clothes. You sent me to break at the end of the interview.
Okay, that's fine. I forget how to do it.
This is Alan Johnson from Marathon Quick Stops, wishing each player out there a great season. Give it 110%, but enjoy it. I know from experience that these are some of the best times of your life. Marathon Quick Stop, run in when you run out. Did you know that by simply downloading the new Dringle Light and Power System Smart Hub app to your mobile device or tablet, you have the freedom to pay your bill, use your usage, and report outages. For more information on this simple way of managing your electric account, contact Greenville Light and Power System at 636-6200 or go online and click on the Smart Hub icon.
Advances in medical imaging technology allow our doctors to detect, diagnose, and treat disease earlier and more accurately with less invasive methods. Ultrasound, MRI, and CT scanning make it possible for a doctor to see what's inside the human body. Never before have physicians had this kind of insight. It's a new day in healthcare. We have the technology. We have the team. Laughlin Memorial Hospital. Whatever you do, do it well.
Welcome back to the Pioneer Pregame Show. Tusculum College Football.
And the Tusculum College Athletic Department respectfully asks that you please stand and for everyone to remove their hats for today's invocation and the playing of the Tusculum alma mater, followed by our national anthem. The Tusculum Marching Band is under the field direction of drum major Jessica Small. Presenting today's invocation is Assistant Athletic Director Dom Donnelly. Let us pray. O gracious and most heavenly Father, we thank you as we gather this night in athletic competition. Bless and protect all.
Thank you.
think so.
No, that's fine. I don't need it. I don't need it. I'm good.
Hometown Realty
I'm good when you're ready.
Selling Greenville and Greene County 1 yard at a time. Every coach knows making the right call is what makes his team successful.
Yeah, I'm going to have to go get some new ones. They're not real good anyway.
Get the home field advantage.
Getting make sure foggy to make the or right something.
Call Hometown Realty and Auction of Greenville. Hometown Realty offers you professional service with local hometown people you know and trust. Call Hometown Realty of Greenville today. 423-639-2345.
You're listening to South Atlantic Conference Football on WSNG with Brian Staten and Joe.
Hey, we welcome you back into the Pioneer Kickoff Show. Tusculum getting set to take on the Shorter Hawks for the first time in these two schools' history that they will be playing each other. The Shorter Hawks out of the Gulf South Conference haven't had a whole lot of success. As a matter of fact, they have lost 18 consecutive games and not won since 2 years ago in 2015 against Mississippi College. They lost the last seven games that year. They lost every game last year, and then they lost their first game this season. A member of the Gulf South Conference, and again, that's not easy. Florida Tech, Delta State, West Alabama, North Alabama, West Florida, West Georgia, Valdosta State, I believe Mississippi College is in that conference, in the Gulf South Conference now, and they have another non-conference game, a Division I contest with Gardner-Webb. So three non-conference games for them, and their 11-game schedule on this season. Let's take a look at these two teams and really the guys who have led them early, but B.J. McCoy has been that guy that can be a powerful offensive threat for this Shorter Hawks team. 21 carries, 78 yards, a 3.7-yard average just last week with a touchdown and a long of 16. And B.J. McCoy is their workhorse. He didn't get a lot as far as yardage inside the 20 because Marsdale kind of hunkered down. But out of Villarica, Georgia, in the Atlanta Sports Academy, know a little thing or two about Villarica down there in the Douglasville, just on that I-20 west towards Birmingham. Outstanding sports programs there at that particular high school, at Villarica High School. So it's a quality offensive running back for Shorter. And you really combine that with Tyler Pullum, who at 19 of 28, a very effective game. And Joseph Ross and Lewis Hayes, as Joe has already talked about, two of the top targets, each with seven catches last week. It's a Pioneer secondary that's going to be challenged. But there's no question that the key for them is, can people like Ivan Hogan's from his linebacker position, Lakeith Brown from his linebacker position. Hopefully we'll see a lot of Chris Matthews tonight. Really like his game and the way he moves around defensively. Can they put pressure from the outside? And can somebody like a Jalen Kesterson, one of our kids from right here in Greene County, in Mosheim out of West Greene High School, can he be a guy that can apply some pressure and move the quarterback Tyler Pullum around? Shorter definitely has some offensive threats. They just didn't get off to a very good start last week. Now, defensively for Shorter, Rodney Jackson had 10 tackles in the game last week, including one for loss. John Gerard with four tackles, but two of them behind the line of scrimmage. Kadir Banks with six tackles last week. Will this be the type of a game where maybe we see Maxwell Joseph break out? Another name that you didn't hear last week for this Pioneer team offensively that we should see breakout today will be Lorenzo Pratt. Was a bit banged up last week, so he didn't do a lot in practice leading into the North Greenfield contest. So we believe a little bit is, you know, we'll see him. And we have dubbed them Thunder and Lightning. Thunder is Maxwell Joseph. He hadn't played in a year. He is a sophomore. He went to junior college out of high school. He came to Tusculum last spring, was ineligible for the year last year, but he was here, paid his own way to be here, and now hopefully we'll see him reaping the rewards of his hard work and his efforts in the offseason. Shaq Harris, will he be more of a factor in the offense? When you look at Shaq Harris in pads as a tight end, he's got all of the intangibles. He's got the look, he's got the build, he's got that strength, and he's got some good hands. He wasn't utilized as a pass-catching receiver as a tight end at UMass, but the Pioneers plan to use him in that offensive attack today. You heard that from Brian Ferguson, the offensive coordinator, talking about needing to utilize Shaq Harris and Lorenzo Pratt a little bit more. So some guys that we didn't call out a whole lot last week, look to call out today. Outside of that, Alex Ogle was outstanding for this Pioneer team. Can can he shred this shorter defense? And again, it's a shorter team that hangs in games. But last week, Mars Hill got out to a quick 21-0 start in the first quarter, and it was on from there. Can the Pioneers get off to that type of a start today? So just a little bit of a breakdown, maybe some of the new names you're going to hear and some of the names that you're going to hear throughout the broadcast here tonight. We hope that you'll enjoy it. You can watch it on TusculumPioneers.com with the live video stream. You can always listen right here on the Pioneer Sports Network, AM 1450 WSMG. And if you happen to be coming to the game, you can pick up the radio, AM 1450, when the sun goes down. We've got an in-stadium feed at 90.9 FM. Joe Bird and I will return. We'll have kickoff. It's Tusculum. It's shorter. We thank our sponsors. Thanks for listening to the Pioneer Kickoff Show as you listen to Pioneer Football here on the Pioneer Sports Network.
Pioneer Football is brought to you by Greenville Light and Power, Hometown Realty and Auction, Laughlin Memorial Hospital, Corley's Pharmacy, Gateway Ford Mazda, Quick Stop Markets, Realty Executives, Greenville Federal Bank, and Terry's Flooring. And now, back to the field with Joe Bird and the voice of the Pioneers, Ryan Staten. Pioneer Football kicks off.
Hey, we welcome you back into Pioneer Field, Tusculum and Shorter University. Brian Staten joined by Joe Bird. Shorter will be receiving to start this football game, Joe, and it's a chance for this Pioneer defense to come out and make an immediate impact. They didn't do that last week against North Greenville as they received the ball, the kickoff, and they just methodically just went right down the field and scored a touchdown and made it 7-0. And then all of a sudden it's 14-0, and we were thinking to ourselves, oh, no, is it a rewind to last year all over again. But today, different opportunity for them.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And this is a good chance for the Pioneers to get off to a good start. Shorter's a good team. They're a developing team coming out of a good conference. But, I mean, let's be perfectly honest, they don't have their quarterback and receiver combination that we saw right out of the gate against North Greenville last year.
No question about that. North Greenville, Will Hunter, Banks, Brooks, you name it. Those guys that they were throwing it to, Sanders at 6 foot six, they had some definite weapons at wide receiver. We've learned about some weapons we have. Let's see if we can have some of those weapons start defensively today. So Gabe Schillings, the freshman, will get set to put foot to leather, and it's game on, Pioneer Nation, here from Pioneer Field. And back deep will be Barnett Bailey. He'll field it at the goal line. He'll bring it out at the 10, at the 15, at the 20, and up to the 30-yard line before he's finally taken down. And the Hawks will start in decent field position, and a good stop defensively for the Pioneers on special teams by Damon Harris, the freshman out of Neptune Beach, Florida. We're thinking about all of our Florida kids that are up here from that great state who are getting ready to be slammed by Hurricane Irma.
Yeah, at a large portion of this Tusculum roster, students from the state of Florida, we know that there's been massive ordered evacuations of hundreds and hundreds of thousands of people. I'm sure somebody in here is related to or know somebody who's one of these evacuees, and so we definitely keep them and their families in our prayers.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line for Shorter, and they'll run it with McCoy right out of the gate, and he might get back to the line of scrimmage, and a nice job defensively for this Pioneer team. Again, for them, also right out of the gate, Colton Strickland was one of the first there for this Pioneer defense. It'll bring up second down and about 9.5.
Take a look at this Shorter roster, Brian. We talked last week about North Greenville being in that hotbed of recruiting right there in the South Carolina area. They've got homegrown players. Shorter has the same benefit, except they just recruit in Georgia. They don't have to go and sleep in a hotel room when these coaches recruit. They can just go home and after they're going within a couple hours of the college itself.
They'll reset the play clock and allow the Hawks, who will be clad in the blue football pants and the gray football shirts trimmed in blue letters and numbers, and the blue football helmets. They move left to right on your radio towards the setting sun, I should say, here to the west end zone at Pioneer Field. And a delay of game. They reset the 25-second clock, and they still didn't get the playoff on time. And it'll back them up five more yards.
Yeah, I've never been one for night games because we waste a perfectly good East Tennessee Saturday afternoon for college football. But the one good thing about it is the setting sun. We're not looking into the sun here at Pioneer Field.
As a matter of fact, when I came to the press box today for the very first time this year, because usually I'm here before then, And I walked in and I thought, man, I got to go get a jacket.
Yeah.
It's exactly what I thought because the sun was not beating on. It wasn't already 85 degrees in here.
And you notice I did go back to the truck and get my jacket because it's quite cool.
I will be putting mine on here very shortly. It is a second down and 14 for the Hawks, and running to the left will be one of the backup running backs for the shorter Hawks, and it looks like that it was not Dickerson. Actually, it was B.J. McCoy. Pardon me, it was B.J. McCoy. So McCoy will take it across the 25 up to about the 26, 27-yard line. It'll bring up third down about 12.
Well, it looks like we have some officials timeout for something.
We've got some kind of an issue that has, I don't know if it's...
Wanting to reset the play clock.
I understand why you reset the clock. You put it 40 seconds on the clock as soon as the play is over with. It's the first home game for everybody, right? Well, not for Max Melton and staff. They'll adjust McCoy once to the left and now to the right. Tyler Pullum will work from the gun. With the snap, under some pressure, he steps up, looking to run. He's got room to go, and he'll make it up to about the 39-yard line. That's where they'll credit him, but that'll still be shy of a first down as D. Alford came up to make the stop. It'll be fourth down about a yard for the Hawks.
And I don't even think Shorter's considering punting their offense to stand on the field. Honestly, when you've lost 18 in a row and you're on the road here in a game like this, try to get something happening early in the game. So they're out, they're going for it.
Well, fourth down and a half yard, not even a full yard for Shorter. And they will line up to go for it. Pullum will come under center. McCoy is directly behind him. He's a big, imposing type back. And Pullum will just put his head down and go right behind the center and will have that first down right behind Tadarius Covington, the 6'2 freshman. He's 333 pounds. He crosses the 40 to the 42. It's first and 10 Shorter.
I will point this out. We do have a big, huge new look here for Tusculum. A lot of new players. Definitely a new look with the orange jerseys and the white helmets. Unfortunately, we're not seeing a new look because the Pioneers are still giving up third and long.
Right. Third down and 11 made it fourth down in less than a yard. And we're still having issues with the clock, it would appear. I don't know if Max wants them to start that 40-second clock on his go. I guess that must be what's going on. I just thought when the play was over with, you just hit reset and went. Well, we haven't started the 25-second clock this time. Maybe we're having some issues with it. Pullum is going to swing out a screen pass, and it's going to be read beautifully by D. Alford as the pass was complete to the wide receiver on this near sideline, the right side, Hancock Burhane, a freshman out of Lilburn, Georgia. And it will be a second down and 13 on the loss of three.
Absolute excellent read by the Pioneer defense there. Knew exactly what Shorter was going to do. And although Shorter completed a pass, they completed it for a loss of about 3 yards.
No score. We're just underway here from Pioneer Field. Great job by D. Alford, who had a touchdown return for fumble return for a touchdown last week. Pull him to pass, and he'll pull the trigger and go deep, and it's just off the fingertips of Alford this time. Incomplete. Check that, Martez Tompkins. I was told that the uniforms would be easy to see and the numbers would be easy to see. Yeah, if you're 5 feet away from him. I'm not.
Actually, I thought it was at first it was number one, obviously not, because that's Shaq Harrison tied in. Then I thought perhaps maybe, hey, it's Matt Simon, number seven now. Finally, we decide it's number two, Martez Tompkins.
Yeah, Martez Tompkins, who already with five interceptions in the season just 2 years ago, one of the top interceptors, tied for 10th most in school history with his tally as a senior for the Tusculum Pioneers. Now third down and long. Can they get off the field? Pressure coming from the outside. They cannot. Complete at the 50, 45, and ripped down at the 39 at Tusculum. And a great open field catch and run for Shorter, as that'll be Joseph Ross, one of the top targets last week, the junior out of Atlanta, Georgia. First and 10 at the Pioneer 39-yard line.
Two third and longs converted by Shorter. The Pioneer defense has got to step up and figure out why it continues to let this break away.
The pressure also just not getting there. That's another issue, I think, for this Pioneer football team. They're just not getting to pull him. He's standing back there in the pocket. Good when he's got time. Hand off. This will be McCoy right up the middle, and he was hit in the hole. And it looked as if it may have been Lakeith Brown. It was who met him initially, a couple of seniors. A gain of a yard down to the 38, second down and nine.
So that means Lakeith Brown is one tackle away from moving into ninth place all time on the Tusculum career tackles list.
So Lakeith, who has had just a stellar career, he came in, didn't know a whole lot about scheme and structure, and he has developed into one of the best tacklers all time here at school history.
He really has. Just a good job, just physical young man.
Second down and nine. No score here in the opening quarter. This is the opening drive of the game. 9:40 on the clock. Blitz comes. Pullum picks it up, but he had to get rid of it in a hurry, and it forced a rushed pass. His receiver was not quite open, Ross, and it's incomplete. It'll bring up third down and nine. Good pressure off the left side of that Pioneer defense.
Ashton Watson helping do his part to really put the pressure on the quarterback and cause an incomplete pass.
So the ball spotted. Well, they moved it up to the 37. Now they move it just beyond the back towards the 38-yard line. So the ball rests in between there. Ross will come to the near side. Also coming to this near side in the slot, Cartez Carr, senior out of Odenville, Alabama. Two wideouts to the far side. McCoy lines up on the right side of Pullum. Out of the shotgun, back to pass, looking, throwing, and it will be incomplete. Good coverage on the far sidelines once again for this secondary, and I'm impressed with what D. Alford brings to the table for this Pioneer team. He was blanketed all over the intended target. It looked like Hayes. It's incomplete. It's fourth down and nine.
Now, once again, Shorter not even really considering punting. They're in that no man's land area.
Or
that area where you can't punt or you can't really kick a field goal, so they're just going to go for it.
You could just do the Maxine, call it the area.
The area. Now I think I'll try to figure out why I'm getting tongue-tied here.
Fourth down and nine. Under center is going to be Pullum. Three wideouts set. I don't know if he's just trying to draw the Pioneers off or not. Pioneers, four down linemen. Pullum under center, and he's actually just going to let the play clock expire. And they're going to burn a five-yard penalty for a delay of game. So they will come out and punt the ball away. It will be Lewis Hayes. The third down pass was intended for him. He'll go back and punt.
Well, that's one of those things where, you know, I'm not sure why that Shorter player just ran across the field and fell down. But that was a smart play by Shorter. Come up, try to get the Pioneers to jump, and maybe make your conversion manageable, or just take the penalty and give your punter room to work.
Hayes with three punts last week, a 39.7-yard average, a long of 44. Gets rid of this one, and we have issues with the punt return, as it's not Altizer back there. It was Alford. It was actually Altizer that was back there, but he ran into Alford, and Alford disrupted him from catching the ball. Fortunately, we had a Pioneer back there to recover it, and the Pioneers take over first and 10.
Well, it really wasn't Altizer. He was coming up to field the ball, and then there was just a crowd of people got into him, and that's almost turned into a very bad situation for Tusculum.
So it's going to bring up first and 10 for the Pioneers, their first possession in a scoreless first quarter, 9:22 to play here in the first. So Ogle under center, max protection at the line of scrimmage with the single setback. Joseph, he'll get the carry running to the left side. He'll cross the 15 up to about the 16-yard line as he's tripped up. But 230 pounds coming straight at you, and it can't feel good when you at least get a hand on his shin bone. And immediately for Shorter, Freddie Hart, the defensive lineman, was shaking that right hand out.
Maxwell Joseph had 18 carries for 48 yards last week. Average of 2.7, but it certainly seems like a lot more than that whenever he touched the football.
It's true. Under nine, well, he had two series where we went backwards, and it was all his stats, unfortunately. Ogle is going to adjust him from the left to the right out of the gun. 8 seconds to get the playoff, and Ogle's pass is going to be complete across the 20 at the 25-yard line, and he just zipped that in there to Rodnell Cruel, who snatches it out of the air up to the 26, moves the chains, first and 10.
Just a good, solid football play there. Shorter bringing the heat, but whenever we had Ogle standing in the pocket picking at his receiver, the Pioneers get the first down.
Just a quick two-step drop for Alex Ogle, and he threw a laser right at Rodnell Cruel, had to leave his feet. on the diving attempt. This is going to be Joseph. Joseph through the line of scrimmage, breaking tackles as he crosses the 30 up to the 32-yard line. As breaking the tackle at the line of scrimmage from Randall Blash, who really kind of just slowed him down enough to get help from the rest of the Hawks. It'll bring up a second down and four after a gain of six.
You know, when you can do that on first down, that really opens up your options here on second. Anytime that you can get that first play for a lot of yardage, now you've got some different things you can do to try to hit shorter deep.
Cruel will come to the near side. Altizer to the far side. Will Boney is in the backfield along with Maxwell Joseph, and Shaq Harris adjusts to the left side of the line. They will run with Maxwell Joseph, and we might have had an illegal formation on the Pioneers or somebody moved since we stopped the play. But there was a lot of moving parts right there for Tusculum. We'll get the call from Max Melton.
False start.
It was a false start.
Number 55. 5 yards.
So we'll move him back 5 yards, make it a second down, and it really should be about nine, what it will be. 7:36 to play here in this opening quarter. Pioneer football team that last week, as far as the penalties were concerned, we had about a third quarter that lasted about 55 minutes. And that was a big reason, and the reason why was because of all the penalties that were called. Tusculum penalized 6 times for 61 yards, but I think 5 of them came in that third quarter.
But oddly enough, North Greenville had a whole lot more than that.
Yeah, 9. Just the yards, they had over 100 yards. Gates on the reception is complete from the 29, and he just bowls over the would-be tackler and Tegan Kirkpatrick. And Kilpatrick just paid a price, but did bring down Evan Gates, who, remind you, played linebacker last year for this team.
Big hit there, big exciting play. And you could hear the roar come up from the crowd and get these people excited, make them want to watch Pioneer football.
6:47 and counting, third down and 4 for the Pioneers as Ogle will come under center. Joseph behind him in the slot to the near side is going to be Gates. They'll run a quick slant. That'll be complete to Altizer, and Altizer just doing his job, possessing and moving the chains. The possession receiver for the Pioneers, you can dub him that, but he is also the guy leading the history. All-time leading yards per reception is Evan Altizer, first and 10 for the Pioneers.
And coming into today's game, he only needed 19 more yards to become the 20th player in Pioneer history with 1,000 yards receiving.
That's saying something, considering the Pioneers have been a pass-happy offense since 2000, when Caleb Slover and Air Raid Dieter Brock introduced that here at Tusculum. 6:10 on the clock, first and 10 for the Pioneers. We are scoreless. This will be Maxwell Joseph, and Joseph will be upended. They're going to say he went down, probably his elbow down at the 42. So he'll gain 3 yards, and it'll bring up a second down and 7 in the middle of that defensive line. LeChaz Langford, a sophomore out of Madison, Alabama.
Ogles continues to kind of telegraph what he's going to do with that handoff to Joseph. Maybe last week I picked that on that earlier. I said, hey, you're tipping your hand. You're showing what you're doing. Maybe he's doing that on purpose for shorter to see. So when we do go with that play action or some sort of quarterback bootleg, it does hide it a little bit better. Hopefully we're going to see some more of that. I like the play action pass.
Second down and 7 from the 42-yard line, and Ogle under center. 5-step drop with time, and across the middle looking for Gates. I don't know if it was tipped at the line of scrimmage or not, but it was awfully weird as it got to Gates. It's incomplete, and it'll bring up 3rd down and 7.
It was, Brian. I could see the umpire standing there in the middle of the field rubbing his hands as if the ball was tipped, and it was an ugly pass, and it was because it was hit, not because of Ogle's work.
Yeah, Ogle can spin it, as they say now. Used to, you know, you can throw it, you can hum it, and now it's you can spin it. 3rd down and 7. The Pioneers have been successful in moving the chains on this drive. A drive that began at their own 11 is out right now to their own 42-yard line in a scoreless first quarter. So Ogle working from the gun, looking. Throwing, complete to Gates at midfield. Out of bounds at the 45-yard line at the 43 of the Hawks. 1st and 10 for the Pioneers on a pickup of close to 17.
And that's what you like to see. We keep talking about the problems defensively, giving up big plays on 3rd down. And in the past, we've seen the Pioneers not be able to convert on 3rd down offensively, but they're doing it here already this evening.
Evan Gates, once again, just that guy who has moved from linebacker to receiver. Last week was the top target for Ogle. First down and 10 from the Hawk 43. Ogle steps up in the pocket, looks for Gates again, and in traffic makes an incredible catch at the 25, takes it down to the 21-yard line. First and 10 for the Pioneers on a pickup of 22.
Rodney Jackson for Shorter right there on the spot, and he delivered a big hit. Fortunately, the Pioneers were able to hang on. Unfortunately for Shorter, we do have one of the defensive front men down on the field.
And the man that's injured is Zion Brown, a freshman out of Decatur, Georgia, and he had the helmet off immediately, maybe dealing with some type of a cramp. In any case, there will be a timeout on the field here as the Pioneers threatening as they have the ball at the 22-yard line. Founded in 1991, the Pioneer Club helps our students succeed athletically and academically as its members provide athletic scholarships as well as support for programs and facilities. All Pioneer Club members receive invites to Pioneer Club events like tailgates, such as today, or hospitality suite invites. Members who join at a certain level or above are admitted free while Pioneer Club at events. More importantly, we don't want you just to join that too. You can attend free events. We want you to help Pioneer Nation. You can do so. Call 636-7303. That's area code 423-636-7303.
I'm a member of the Pioneer Club, and you should be too.
Joe and I work hard at it, so you guys sign up. Handoff. This will be Lorenzo Pratt. He'll have his first carry as he'll take it from the 22 inside the 20 down to the 19. And there's that little shiftiness, thunder and lightning. And Maxwell Joseph, who just brings the lumber. And Pratt, who avoided a would-be tackle in the backfield, adjusted and still picked up three where he could have lost three, picked up three.
Actually, I went to the Pioneer Club tailgate before the game started, and one of my students from West Green, Starla Bradley, was out working, serving. I appreciate her efforts out here tonight.
Outstanding. Second down and 7 for this Pioneer football team. No score in the first quarter. Here's Pratt again. He stumbles as he makes it to the line of scrimmage this time, and he will barely get back to the line. That interior defensive line for Shorter there to put a stop to that. 4 minutes to play in the opening quarter, and the Pioneers face yet another third down.
And it's a good time for me to point out, too, in the band here tonight, I see several West Green High School students coming out to play for the Tusculum band. I don't want to call them out by name because I'm afraid I'll miss someone, but I will congratulate those folks when I see them on Monday morning.
But they are here.
They are here, maybe future Pioneers.
Third down and 8 from the 20 for the Pioneers. Ogle, 5 of 6 in the game, 58 yards. Pioneers needing to convert in a scoreless first quarter. Once again, it'll be on Alex Ogle's right arm. He'll throw incomplete. This one may be a little bit too hot to handle for the Pioneers. It'll be incomplete, intended for Gates at about the 15-yard line. They look over to the sideline as if to say, what do we do? Esparza is ready. Cantrell, the holder, is ready. And they will send the kicking team out to attempt a field goal, which would be from about 37 yards.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to measure. Looks like it's going to be 37. But fortunately, he's not having to look into the sun, so that is one good thing. A little bit of wind coming into his face, not too bad. So with Esparza's leg, if he can get it on target, it should be okay.
So Esparza from 37. O'Grady to hold it, Cantrell to hold it. O'Grady snapped it, and the kick by Esparza is up and good.
I actually believe, Brian, that was Isaac DeLagos.
It was DeLagos. As I sit down there and look at it now, I was like, wow, made that change. So we will go to a break and come back and make sure we've got all the names right and everything else is squared away. 3:20 to play here in this opening quarter. The Pioneers strike first. It's Tusculum 3 and Shorter 0 as you listen to Pioneer football here on the Pioneer Sports Network.
The official grocery store of Pioneer Athletics.
Pharmacy, we know that your time is valuable, so we fill your prescription just as quickly as we can.
And moving your prescriptions is as easy as ABC, and the C stands for Corley's Pharmacy on Snaps Ferry Road, 638-7552.
This is Tusculum College Football on WSMG with the voice of the Pioneers, Ryan Satan, and
Isaac Gallegos with the 37-yard field goal. Caps a nice drive, which began back at the Pioneer 11-yard line, and the Pioneers take a 3-0 lead. Kickoff fielded and returned out to about the 27-yard line, and that's where it'll be first and 10 for the Shorter Hawks.
Aaron Bryant receiving that ball right about the 6 or 7, and he can get a 20-yard return to start the Hawks off on their second offensive series.
So first and 10 for them. 3:15 on the clock here in this opening quarter. Moving towards the setting sun here at Pioneer Field is Shorter. They will adjust as they break the huddle. Wide receiver, which is in the backfield. Play action pass. Pullum looking out of the backfield, and it's going to be caught, and it's going to be fumbled, and it's going to be recovered by the Pioneers. On the catch, the Shorter Hawks give it up, and Matt Simon, who dislodged the ball last week from a North Greenville receiver, is the recipient of a Pioneer big hit as he covers the fumble at the 42-yard line. The Pioneers have it, leading 3-0.
Lewis Hayes for Shorter making the catch and running right into wide open space. Pioneer defense shut him down, delivered the hit to knock the football off and create the turnover.
Just difficult to pick up the numbers in fast motion from where we sit. Tiny numbers, they are white at least. Can't at least see them, but when they bunch up on the jersey, it's difficult to see the numbers. So first and 10, the ball officially at the 44 of Shorter. After the game's first turnover, here's Maxwell Joseph with a hole. He goes up and over and flips over the defender at the 35-yard line. Dangerously comes down, thankfully, on his back. I have seen one kid nearly lose the ability to walk again last night in a high school football game. Thankfully, prayers have been answered for Anthony McGee, and we know that he will be recovering quickly and be able to lead a healthy life, but that's just a scary moment.
It is when a player goes end over end and his feet are literally straight up in the air and it's coming down toward his head. It's scary.
8-yard gain for Maxwell Joseph, and he will power his way down to the 35, maybe the 34. They're only going to give him the 35, so he'll be a yard shy of the first, where it'll be third down and less than a yard.
That was a Maxwell Joseph-type yard situation because we know what he's capable of doing, pushing that pile, but you'd almost think, hey, after going end over end, why don't you take willing to set this one out?
No, man, leave him out there. His adrenaline's got to be sky high after that.
I didn't say bring him out. I said give the ball to somebody else.
Under 2 minutes to play here in the opening quarter. Third down, less than a yard from the 35 of Shorter after the fumble recovered by Matt Simon of the Pioneers. They'll put Gates in motion. They'll still hand it off to Joseph, and he will bust it into the secondary at the 30. He'll take it down to the 26-yard line and move the chains. First and 10 for the Pioneers. Nehemiah Reddish, or Nemo, on the stop for the Hawks. First and 10, Tusculum.
Another big pickup for the Pioneers, and they absolutely have to put points on the board on this drive, because to get that turnover where they did, you know that the Pioneers want to strike while it's everything's hot.
Maxwell Joseph now 6 carries, 30 yards so far in this game right here through this first quarter. Under center will be Ogle. Play action pass, and he's going to be sacked. That's just a great read by Shorter. It was supposed to be a bootleg, but the Hawks and the defensive end not fooled on that particular play, and it's going to bring up second down and long. And firing off from his linebacker position, Kareem Taylor, the 6-foot sophomore, comes up with the big stop.
Brian, take a look at some of the scores from around the conference. As we already know, Carson Newman winning at home today, 41-14 over St. Augustine's. Catawba, big upset win on the road at FCS VMI. They defeated the Keydets 27-20. And last report, Newberry at Virginia Union. That game is tied at 17 in the third quarter.
Wow, we got a report. Loss of 10 on the play on the sack of Alex Ogle. Toss left side. This is going to be Joseph, and they come up with the stop in the backfield. Here the Shorter Hawks, Jaquan Alves, the junior from Dadeville, Alabama, with that stop. And it's going to bring up third down and forever. The only problem is Alves will have to leave the field for a play as he lost his headgear.
And the Pioneers have gone backwards after the big pickups. Right now they are just about where this drive started when they got the turnover.
So 20 seconds to play in the quarter. Tusculum leading the game 3-0. Keandre Banks is into the game. He's a wide out to the right. Lynch on the line of scrimmage to the right with Gates in the slot, and Altizer to the near side. So Ogle will come under center. 5 seconds on the game clock. And Ogle will get the snap off on third down and 26, and he'll look across the middle. The pass is going to be – did he hang on to it? I don't think so. I believe Gates went up, and he had it for a second in triple coverage, and he almost made a highlight reel catch, but he could not hang on to it, and that's the final play of the quarter. At the end of one, the Tusculum Pioneers lead the Shorter Hawks. It's Tusculum 3. It's Shorter 0. Pioneer football continues here from Pioneer Field after this on the Pioneer Sports Network.
At the end of the first quarter, your score is a touchdown.
Down from one place to another. Sometimes you just want to enjoy the journey on the way to the destination. And part of what makes it a little more enjoyable is an appreciation for the folks who help you get there. At Ingles, we know that the people who send you on your way are the same ones who keep you coming back.
I think you should take it for a spin.
Are you serious? Ingles, all the ingredients for family. The first date. Only one chance to make that first impression. Don't worry, this might be new for you, but Ingles has been there before. From flowers to the freshest ingredients, we have everything you need to put your best foot forward.
I'm so sorry.
Remember, you can't get to happily ever after without once upon a time.
Wow, funny running to you.
Ingles, all the ingredients for family.
Executives guide you home. Pioneer football on WSMG with Brian Staten and
37 yards. We welcome you back into Pioneer Field at the end of one quarter. The Tusculum Pioneers lead at 3-0. And Tusculum Pioneers on this drive stalling out because the Shorter defense came up with a loss of 16 on two plays, a loss of 10 on a sack on Ogle, and then a loss of 6 to Maxwell Joseph, and then an incompletion to Evan Gates. So Cantrell on to a pooch punt this one, and looking to pin the Hawks deep, and D. Alford makes the catch at the 6-yard line, and sure enough, the Shorter Hawks will be starting from deep in their own territory. A well-executed special teams play by Hunter Cantrell, one of the best in the business.
It was, and unfortunately the Pioneers did not get the points off that turnover they needed, but they're able to get the field driven down, and Shorter's got a lot of work to do if they're going to go down and get their first points of the game.
So the Pioneers, who lead it 3-0, and I was looking just to see if they had, I didn't think they did. They didn't have like the scoring drive on that score.
No, the stats have changed up. We've got the defensive stats on here and not the scoring drives that we normally have had in the past.
But it should be
right there. Okay, it's up at the top.
Yeah. First down and 10 from the 6-yard line for Shorter. This is going to be B.J. McCoy right up the middle for maybe a yard. And on the stop is P.J. Green for this Tusculum Pioneer defense. It'll bring up second down and about 9 at the 7.
Green and Malik Goodman both doing a good job sniffing out that play, and then just basically no gain for the Hawks.
Of course, Javon is his printed name. We affectionately know him as P.J., who came up with that stop. He just had a breakout year last year for this Pioneer football team on this defense. Still a very young Pioneer defense. We do have some seniors out there, like Lakeith Brown, but for the most part, a very young defense. Martez Tompkins, yet another senior. Jalen Kesterson, a senior. Second down, 9.5 to pass. Under pressure by Kesterson. Rolling the pocket, chased by Lakeith Brown, and he gets to him. Brings him down by the shoulder pads at the 10-yard line. It's going to bring up a third down, about 6 coming up for the Hawks.
You mentioned Jalen Kesterson, and we really see him in action for one of the first good times tonight, if maybe not even for the season. Jalen coming in as a graduate student.
Right. Talked about being a senior, just some leadership. He still had a year of eligibility, and I believe he was like, you know what? I think I'll just play some football for that last year.
Yeah, there you go. Go Buffs.
Third down, and we'll call it 7. Ball is at the 10-yard line. They need just beyond the 17 for a first. Pullum will work from the gun on third down and 7. Pressure coming once again. Pullum will get rid of it. It'll be incomplete. A diving attempt. As a matter of fact, if he had made the catch, that being Cartez Carr, he would have been not counted because he went out of bounds on his own. The official threw the hat, and it's going to bring up fourth down.
Defense continuing to play well now. A lot of pressure coming from the defense and putting the pressure on Shorter, forcing the three and out and punting with the punter in the end zone.
Pullum now 3 of 7, 36 yards in this football game passing, and he's been running for his life, but he's been running effectively. Might want to say that. He has done a decent job in avoiding the rush. Altizer on the punt will be driven back to his own 43, splits two defenders, and now runs out of real estate left. Will turn around and come back to the right, and he's got daylight at the 50. Altizer also has blockers at the 40, at the 30, before he's finally caught from behind at the 25-yard line and taken down there. It will be first and 10 for the Pioneers on the special teams return by Evan Altizer.
Exciting return by Altizer. He just refused to give up, refused to go down. And honestly, the reason he got chased down from behind is because he had such a convoy of blockers, he couldn't use his white lightning speed to get out into the open, and that allowed Shorter to pull him down from behind, or he might have broken it to the end zone.
He dubbed that nickname White Lightning. So it is a first and 10 for the Tusculum Pioneers. Great field position for Tusculum as Altizer fielding it at his own 42 over the shoulder and returning it to the Hawk 25-yard line. So 12:59 to play in the opening half. 3-0 Tusculum. Ogle and company out there moving left to right on your radio heading to the west end zone. This will be Maxwell Joseph. He'll start right. He'll stay right, 20. Maxwell Joseph, 10. Joseph at the 5, and Joseph into the end zone. Touchdown, Pioneers. Touchdown, Maxwell Joseph, as he touches Peter from 25 yards.
Hey, maybe just like last week against North Greenville, it took these Pioneers a quarter to get warmed up, and we're seeing right now, just on their first couple opportunities here in the second quarter, show what these guys can do.
Already the longest rush of the year for the Pioneers. Previously, Joseph, a 21-yard run last week was the long. That one goes for 25, and the Pioneers add to their lead thanks to a 32-yard punt return by Evan Altizer to set them up into a good scoring position. So Isaac Gallegos, the young freshman out of Knoxville, who has already hit a 37-yard field goal, must have had a competition this week, would be my guess. And Gallegos won the job this week. This point after is up, and the point after is good. We go to a break. We're back to Pioneer Field. 12:50 to play here in this opening half with your new score. It's Tusculum 10 and Shorter 0. Pioneer football continues here from Pioneer Field and Orange Wave Night on the Pioneer Sports Network. Established in 1794, Tusculum's beautiful campus is nestled in the foothills of the Great Smoky Mountains, where students from all around the world have found a home. Tusculum can help you pioneer your path to success. Visit online for more information at tusculum.edu or call 423-636-7300 and discover the Pioneer experience for yourself.
Did you know that by simply downloading the new Greenville
app, Indiana State?
Yep. View your usage history, receive email or text alerts, and report outages. For more information on this simple way of managing your electric account, contact Greenville Light Power System at 636-6200.
You're listening to South Atlantic Conference Football on WSMG with Brian Staten.
One play, 25 yards for Maxwell Joseph to get into the end zone. The Gallegos kick makes it 10-0. That's your Terry's Flooring scoring recap. And this kickoff, boom by Shillings, through the end zone.
Brian, we talk about Maxwell Joseph. He's out of Naples, Florida, East Central Community College, Naples High School. In Naples, Florida right now, it's looking like is in direct path of Hurricane Irma. So we definitely hope for Maxwell Joseph's family and friends that those folks are in a nice, safe place, because it could get ugly before morning.
I'd like to know that they might even be here at this home opener.
Yeah, that would be a great place for those folks to be.
Yeah. even though East Tennessee is going to feel the brunt of this for sure.
It's looking like it's tracking off a little bit to the west, but I know the area farmers, they do hope we do get some rain out of this thing first of the week.
So first and 10 at the 25 for the Hawks. They trail 10 to nothing, and they will try. It looked like they're going to fake a bootleg, and then all of a sudden they went ahead and handed it off, and that's not good news because standing in the way for the Pioneers defensively was Josh Forrest, this young sophomore out of Lawrenceville, Georgia, with a loss of 5 on the play. It'll bring up second down. We'll call it 14 at the 21.
I'll just go ahead and bring it up that I know something about being stuck in flooding from a hurricane, and so I feel for those folks.
I'm not laughing because of the situation. I'm just laughing because of the way Joe handled the situation. That probably wasn't the smartest thing I could have ever done.
We'll talk about that in a few weeks when we go to Pembroke.
Joe has already got the hotel picked out for us because we know where we can stay anyway. This is going to be McCoy, and there's just not much running room right now against this defensive front, and they are playing well. A young man that played outstanding last week for the Pioneers, and that's Devin Woodson, the sophomore out of Central South Carolina. Kind of made fun of the way that South Carolina names their cities. You got Due West, you've got North South Carolina, you've got 96 South Carolina, and now Central South Carolina, where he's from. But he had an outstanding game last week, and Woodson comes up with the stop there.
Brian, no score of interest. University of Tennessee playing at home today. The Vols are up on Indiana State 35-7 and early in the fourth quarter.
And despite a UT Knoxville home game and a home opener, Pioneers have a good crowd here for their home opener. Send a man in motion across the formation, and they'll throw it out to the flat to that man, Lewis Hayes, but it's well defended by the Pioneers, just reading their routes, just reading exactly what Shorter is giving them. The Pioneers not giving up much since the opening possession of this football game, and just a nice defensive play by Chris Matthews, a guy that we didn't call out a whole lot last week, just made one tackle, but he really burst onto the scene last year. It's going to bring up fourth down and 10.
Brian, helping the attendance today is the women's soccer team. A lot of those players are here because their tournament got canceled this weekend.
Hayes to punt it. His last punt of 47 yards. That will be a season high, and Altizer is not going to ask for the fair catch. He'll come down with it, and then Barnett Bailey, the junior from McCunna, Georgia, comes up with the stop right at the point of the catch. But it's first and 10 for the Pioneers. They'll scrimmage from their own 37.
And Lady Pioneer soccer team was scheduled to be playing in Georgia a couple games this weekend, but because of the impending weather down there, that tournament and their schedule had to be altered.
We'll talk about that coming up at the half with a look at this week in Tusculum Athletics. What is not happening for not only women's soccer, but also the men's golf team that was supposed to be at Kiowa Island Monday and Tuesday. That probably wouldn't be a very good place to be either. 10:40 to play here in this opening half. The Pioneers leading 10-0. Here's Maxwell Joseph just running loose in the secondary and just taking would-be tacklers with him across the 40, 45, and up to the 47-yard line. It'll be very close to a first and 10 for the Pioneers.
Shorter defense coming in, trying their best to pull the ball away from Joseph's grasp. Very, very strong runner, strong arm strength to hold onto that football, and they can't get it away from him.
Austin Porter on that stop for Shorter. It is a first down and 10 at the 47. Clock runs with 10:20 to play here in this opening half. Here's Altizer on a slant, complete at the 45. Breaks the tackle, 40, 35, and down to the 34-yard line. Had to be stopped by Javarius Wood, the sophomore from Commerce, Georgia. It moves the chains to the 39 of the Hawks.
And with that pass, I almost want to think that gave him the yards he needed to move over 1,000 yards for his
over
career.
Over 1,000 yards for his career. That is Evan White Lightning Altizer. Throwing the pockets. Ogle says, come back to me, help me out. Ogle does just that, comes back to him and helps him out at the 12, at the 11-yard line with the catch. Altizer says, I need a break. It'll be first down and 10 from the 11 for the Pioneers.
If he didn't have the 19 yards he needed prior to that play, he certainly does now. It's his third catch of the game, moving up and moving up into the Pioneer record books.
Yeah, had a couple of short catches early in the first quarter, just kind of moving the chains type catches, but those last two back-to-back long attempts for the Pioneer out of just outside of Charlotte and Weddington, North Carolina. This will be Maxwell Joseph, makes a man miss in the backfield on first down and 10. He'll cross the 10 down to the 8-yard line, gain 3, bring up second down and 7.
Yeah, not a great pickup, but they did move the ball forward a little bit closer to the goal line, setting up second down, and we'll call it a long 7 here, Brian.
So to bring up that second down, for this Pioneer football team. Altizer with a 32-yard punt return already in this game. Now he's kind of gone back-to-back. A 23-yard reception has set the Pioneers up at the 11 for a first and 10. Now facing second down and 7. Ogle back to pass. Blitz is on. It's picked up. And the pass intended for the tight end, Shaq Harris. And I think just a little miscommunication. Ogle had to let it fly just a little bit earlier than he wanted to. It's incomplete. And it'll bring up third down.
Yeah, Xavier Hughley there for Shorter crashing through the Tusculum front and causing Alex Ogle to have to get rid of that football a little bit faster than he intended.
So on this drive, Evan Altizer has factored prominently a 19-yard reception on a catch and run and then a 23-yard reception, bailing out his quarterback, coming back to help, setting up the Pioneers in outstanding field position once again, leading already 10-0, and the Pioneers will burn a timeout here. They had the play clock winding down inside of 10 seconds, and they really weren't set at the line of scrimmage. Each and every Monday now, following Pioneer football season, joined myself, Pioneer coach Jerry Odom, our Pioneer Players of the Week from Applebee's here in Greenville, as we review the previous game and preview our next game. That will be on Monday nights now here in Greenville and on the Pioneer Sports Network beginning at 7 o'clock. Come enjoy the benefits of the great food in the neighborhood at Applebee's while supporting the Pioneer football team. If you can't make it, you can always listen locally on AM 1450 WSMG or worldwide through TusculumPioneers.com. We appreciate all those who listen on the internet to the radio broadcast or watch on the video feed here from Tusculum College. Nick Forsberg and his and the staff of that group doing a great job learning how to do all of this video, and just to bring you some of the exciting action, a different look, field perspective from up high as well. And appreciate their efforts and what they are doing to improve your viewing experience of Pioneer Athletics. Third down and 7 from the 8-yard line. Ogle will back out of the gun. Max protection. Looking. Pass is going to be complete. And losing yards will be Keandre Banks. He caught it at the 4 and then retreated, just trying to make a couple of plays. And he'll lose yards basically back to the line of scrimmage at the 8-yard line. So we'll send Gallegos out to attempt a short field goal.
Yeah, that's not what you want to do. Wouldn't have got the first down they needed either way, so credit him for trying to make something happen, but you definitely don't want to move yourself backwards 4 yards when you're near the goal line.
Well, attempt from 25. O'Grady to snap it. Cantrell to hold it. Isaac Gallegos, the freshman, to kick it. And a nice job by Cantrell to get the snap down. It was a bit low. Cantrell gets it down, and Gallegos puts it straight through. We go to a break with your new score. 8-10 to play here in this opening half. It's now Tusculum 13 and Shorter 0. Pioneer football continues after this on the Pioneer Sports Network.
Team striving for excellence. The Tusculum Experience offers state-of-the-art facilities for practice and game days. If you seek a championship atmosphere, the Tusculum Experience is for you. Visit online through TusculumPioneers.com. Call 423-636-7300 to discover the Pioneer Experience for yourself.
All right, Popsy, I'm going to think of a special word, and you have to guess what it is.
Let's do it.
It starts with an F.
Football?
No.
Ball?
Wrong again.
I give up.
You, of all people, should have guessed it. It's flooring.
I should have known.
Well, fall is the perfect time to get new flooring, you know, for the holidays get here.
Do you ever take a day off?
Nope, gotta keep you hopping. Stop in and see my pops at Terry's Floor.
This is Tusculum College Football on WSMG with the voice of the Pioneers, Ryan Staton.
Six plays, 55 yards, a 25-yard field goal. Our Terry's Flooring scoring recap. Pioneers leading at 13-0. And Schilling. What? Will Tommy? What? He just put that through the end zone once again. Nice scoring drive once again for this Tusculum Pioneers, leading now 13-0 on the 25-yard field goal.
Another good play. Got points on the board and knocked the 7 points the Pioneers had hoped for, but still stretching their lead 13-0 here. 8 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in the first half.
So the Tusculum Pioneers. And the Shorter Hawks meeting for the first ever time between these two schools. First and 10. Pullum is in trouble, and he's going to be sacked back at the 19-yard line. A meeting at the quarterback. Colton Strickland led the efforts, the preseason all-conference selection, and he was finished off by an orange wave themselves. It'll bring up second down and 6.
When Shorter got his football program up and going at the NCAA Division II level, there was some talk about them coming into the South Atlantic Conference. And honestly, I would have liked to have seen them done that. It would have extended the conference into the state of Georgia. And they are a better fit playing in the South Atlantic Conference than they are the Gulf South, quite frankly.
No question about it. And their curriculum meets that of the South Atlantic Conference. Yeah. Second down and 16. Pullum trying to set up a screen, and it's well covered by the Pioneer defense once again. Lakeith Brown. The pass was intended for Lemuel Cobbs, the junior from Riverdale, Georgia, but there was just so much pressure in the backfield. Jerry Odom right now has it dialed up, and he is sending those guys in the backfield.
You know, really, with the exception of Shorter, North Greenville to an extent as that associate member, but Shorter, everybody in the Gulf South either has the name of a state or the word state in their name, and you mentioned those at the start of the game.
Third down and 16 for Shorter. Struggling since their opening drive on their offense. Pullum under pressure, rolls the pocket to the right. Strickland giving chase, trying to lob it downfield. Martez Tompkins just got tied up with the defender, and they just kind of clipped the heels of each other. Tompkins goes down, or he might have had his first interception of the year. As it is, it's incomplete, and it's fourth down.
I've never been exactly shy about pointing out the South Atlantic Conference has done some things over the last few years that I don't think are in their best interest. They let good schools that meet the SAC profile slip away and then bring in others that really don't have any business there because they don't meet the traditional profile of the South Atlantic Conference.
Right. A few issues with the play clock here today. Get that sorted out again. 7:13 on the game clock. Altizer stares into the backfield, awaiting the punt from Lewis Hayes. Low snap and nearly blocked. It's going to create a penalty, and this could be roughing the punter. This could be a break for Shorter. Hayes had to go down to a knee to field it, and to me, just from the naked eye, I don't know if Hayes went down to a knee. If that was the case, he's down.
You know, I kind of agree there. I don't know how close he did get to the game, but this is going to be a penalty against the Pioneers because we had somebody going in trying to block, and just absolutely put the punter on his back.
If it's roughing the punter, it's 15 yards. If it's running in, it's 5. And the punt was fielded and returned to the 45. No, it's just running in.
On the defense, 5-yard penalty, replay, fourth down.
So they are going to let Hayes kick it again, and they're marking it off against Shorter, and it should be going the other way, boys. Where was the original line of scrimmage again? Well, the guy with the lollipop moved. So they did get it right. It was the 19 to the 24. There you go.
We've already seen Evan Altizer in action. This could be dangerous for Shorter if they had the opportunity. Just it wasn't a very good return. Tack it on and back them up there, but they're going to re-kick it. And if Altizer breaks this, wrong move.
High snap. Hayes brings it down, gets away a better punt. It's a wobbler that Altizer will field, and he did go down to a knee, and he knew it, and he gave himself up, and he fields it at the 48. So the 5-yard penalty basically was the difference in the starting field position. So it was a push.
It was. It just took a few seconds off the clock here, and now Pioneer's going to be starting at their own 47.
Shorter has not picked up a first down since their opening drive. Tusculum 9 first downs to Shorter's 2 so far in the game. Tusculum 3 of 6 on third down. Shorter now just 1 of 6 in the game. Pioneers 157 yards to Shorter's 51. They've had the short field a couple of times as well, thanks to some turnovers. 6:54 to play. in the first half. Ogle to pass, buying some time, rolling the pocket. He'll have a receiver come back and help him out at the 35, and losing ground once again to the 37-yard line is Rodnell Cruel, but the key was he came back to help his quarterback, and it's a big gainer, close to 17. First and 10 for the Pioneers.
Big game for the Pioneers. Ultimately, those couple of yards of loss running backwards, not that tragic, because you picked up a big chunk to get yourself in shorter territory.
First and 10 from the Hawk 37, and the handoff nearly fumbled. I believe that's Jordan Shippey, who has checked into the game. Across the 35, he'll take it down to the 32-yard line, and the exchange between quarterback and running back nearly disastrous, but Shippey did a good job to hang on to it and gain some vital yards, a gain of 6, bring up 2nd and 4.
It was as Shippey bouncing his way through, does, you know, not real tall runner, so he can get in between those holes and pick up his yards in the middle that way.
An 8.2-yard average last week against North Greenville on just 4 carries. I believe he was the difference when he came in on that 4th offensive series. Here he is battling for first down yardage. There is a penalty flag thrown back in the area where Shippey broke to daylight on the left side. They were pointing at, I believe, Shaq Harris for possibly a hold. It would have been enough for a first down right at the sticks, but we'll check the penalty.
Yeah, I can almost guarantee you it's going to be a hole, because you could see it over on that what would be the Pioneers' left side of the offensive line.
Shaq Harris, the UMass graduate, just an imposing figure for the Pioneers. You know, it just seems like Jerry goes out and finds those tight ends. Last year, Lorenzo Mitchell.
On the offense, number one.
And when Shaq Harris gets a hold of you, you're going to probably see it. Just a big human. He's upset with himself over there in the huddle. He can see it.
6'3", 235 pounds, Shaq Harris.
Yeah. I mean, he and Maxwell Joseph, running back and tight end, they're basically the same mold. So Shippey stays in the backfield. It'll bring up 2nd down and about 14 yards back at the 42-yard line. 4 wide out set. Harris is set in the slot to the right. Shippey lined up behind Ogle, who's under center. 5-step drop. Looking, and throwing deep. It slipped out of his hands and fortunate to keep possession. Standing back there in the middle of that defensive backfield was Kevin Knight, the 5'11 senior, and I'm not sure how he didn't pick that one off, as Ogle would like to have had that one back as soon as he let it go.
Yeah, wasted opportunity there for the Pioneers, and now between bad plays and going backwards, Pioneers looking at 3rd and 15.
So the penalty hurting the drive a bit, slowing the momentum down for the Pioneers. Send 3 wideouts to the far side, bring Altizer to the near side for Tusculum. Keandre Banks and Eric Lynch are to that far side. Ogle's going to back up into the gun with Shippey flanked to his right shoulder. Moving left to right, there's the snap from the gun. Ogle under pressure, lets it go to Altizer, complete inside the 30. He'll take it to the 26. That'll move the chains. 1st and 10 on a pickup of 17 for the Pioneers.
Another pickup for the Pioneers. If I'm correct, that takes them to 11 for the game.
Their 11th first down, correct. More importantly, 4 of 7 on 3rd downs. Not more importantly, but a good stat.
Yeah, good stat.
1st down and 10 for the Pioneers. Again, 3rd down was the Achilles heel for Tusculum last year. So far this season on 3rd downs, their percentage much better. Talk about that coming up. Shippey starts right, moves back to the left, cut back at the 20. Shippey at the 15, at the 10, to the 5, and written out of bounds at the 2-yard line. 1st and goal for the Pioneers, Jordan Shippey for Tusculum.
And he created a lot of that himself. He got a good block to get into space, but he was being tracked down. Shippey's fast. He's also strong because he had 2 shorter hogs closing in on him, and he just stiff-armed him out of the way to get all the way down to the 2.
Long 3rd down pickup for the Pioneers by Evan Altizer, and then Jordan Shippey with a big run to daylight. 1st and goal with Maxwell Joseph returning the game, and Will Boney, he will be the fullback to hopefully lead the way for Maxwell Joseph. Tusculum converting 43% last week on 3rd downs, a huge improvement, almost 20% from a year ago. Joseph takes some contact in the backfield, and I think they're going to say he was down before he crossed the goal line, and I'm not sure how you can have said that or had seen that, But that will be the case, and he'll be stopped shy of the goal line by a half yard.
Yeah, if they could see it, that's a very good from where we are, because there was about 20 of, or the 22 players all piled into one little spot there.
With the ball being ripped free and free in the end zone. But they apparently had blown it dead prior to that. So we'll try it again. Second down and goal from just inside the one-yard line. Last week was a little bootleg action to Evan Gates. Will this just be Maxwell Joseph time on second down? Gates will go in motion. They will hand it off to Joseph. He will meet contact at the line of scrimmage and plow his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Tusculum. Touchdown, Maxwell Joseph, crossing pay dirt from a yard out. His second touchdown of the game, his third of the year.
Anytime the Pioneers can get the ball that close to the goal line, now you finally have to feel real good about your options of scoring, because Joseph's such a strong runner. You know he's going to get that 1 or 2 yards.
3:27 on the clock, and the Pioneers reach pay dirt once again. It has been Gallegos from 25, Joseph from 25 yards on a run. Gallegos, a 37-yard field goal was how we got things started. And now Gallegos will attempt his second extra point of the game and looking to give Tusculum a 20-0 lead. O'Grady snaps it, Cantrell holds it, and Gallegos puts it up and through, and the point is good. 3:27 to play. We go to a break with your new score here from Pioneer Field. Tusculum 20 and Shorter 0. Pioneer football continues after this on the Pioneer Sports Network. Tusculum College is Tennessee's first college. Established in 1794, Tusculum's beautiful campus is nestled in the foothills of the Great Smoky Mountains, where students from all around the world have found a home. Tusculum can help you pioneer your path to success. Visit online for more information at tusculum.edu or call 423-636-7300 and discover the Pioneer experience for yourself.
Things happen just about everywhere today.
Every day the news brings more bad news. I guess that isn't news. The world is full of problems. You may have asked yourself, what can one person do? In a word, plenty. From hospital volunteers to volunteers in service clubs and church groups, community individuals are making things better. Volunteers. Some good news for a change. Greenville Federal Bank, member FDIC. Banking made easy.
Pioneer football on WSMG with Brian Staten and Joe Burr.
3:27 on the clock. Pioneers lead it 20-0. Gabe Schillings puts it foot to leather. And this one will go 5 yards deep into the end zone once again. And Schillings just starting to warm up, as this one will be a touchdown for a touchback. And Shorter will take it over, first and 10 at the 25. A 7-play, 53-yard drive, highlighted by the third down reception to Evan Altizer on third down and 14. Pioneers get the first, and then Jordan Shippey takes it from that spot down to the 2, a 23-yard run. And the Pioneers, Maxwell Joseph, pounds it in from there. That's your Terry's Flooring scoring recap, with the Pioneers lead it now 20-0.
Yeah, we'll talk about these kickers. Both of them are freshmen, what we're seeing here today, so you have to like that aspect of the Pioneer special teams maybe coming up for the next 4 years.
Yeah, we can talk about a lot of the way this Pioneer team works. Just youth is served here. So Shorter, who has not picked up a first down since their opening drive, will have a new running back in the backfield. That's Royce Thomas. He's listed as a defensive back out of Navarre, Florida. He'll pick up a first down as he carries would-be tacklers across the 35 and up to the 37, 38. He'll gain 13. It'll be first and 10.
That could be Weldron Ford. They actually have 224s here.
I see that. Yeah.
Actually, most of their numbers are doubled up here on the roster, Brian.
I do see that now, yes. So another handoff. They got multiple numbers. You just got to find the guy who's wearing the offensive number. So Weldron Ford, the freshman out of Opelika, Alabama. He'll get another carry, and he'll take it to the 39, gain a yard. It'll bring up second down and 9.
But, you know, I really didn't notice this earlier, but there's a whole lot of numbers that are doubled up.
And I've done that a couple of times. I've looked down and say, why is this guy? It's Elijah Gilbert, the wide receiver. 88, and I called him Hancock Burhane, who made the catch, and I looked down and thought, well, he's not a defensive lineman. So it's second down and nine. And I did get that note, by the way, and I tried to make some notes about, all right, well, who's got doubled up numbers, and I didn't do a good enough job looking over the roster.
Well, you know, we also have to take note that the shorter radio folks came over and told us before the game, as far as two deep goes, we don't know. We find out when they take the field.
Yeah, they kind of figure out who's going to be out there. And that's okay. Pioneer football team leading it 20-0 and dominating the statistic. 220 yards of offense to 65, but a good start to this drive on the rush by Weldron Ford of 13 yards with a minute 40 left to the half. Pioneer offense will receive the second half kickoff, and this pass is going to be caught, I believe, by Hayes. It is. Nice catch in traffic, and he did that right in front of Quadri Allen down to the Pioneer 45-yard line. So finally some passing room for Tyler Pullum, but he was still flush from the pocket and made a throw off balance complete.
Now Pullum did it. He created that. He was being chased by the Pioneers, ran into space, waited until his receiver got open and made the play for the Hawks.
So a minute 20 left in the half, and a timeout has been asked for by Shorter. We invite you to stay tuned for our Pioneer Halftime Report. Coming up, we'll have a look at this week in Tusculum Athletics volleyball team. What a home opener they had, and a South Atlantic Conference opener as well, as they welcome Carson Newman. If only it had resulted into a, or if their result could have been on a more positive note. We'll talk about that. Plus, who is not playing this weekend as the effects of Hurricane Irma making its way through the Gulf and coming up the peninsula and the spine of Florida? What has that done to schedules in Pioneer Athletics? And the Pioneer soccer team will have their second home game tomorrow here at Pioneer Field beginning at 3 o'clock. We'll talk about that, plus your halftime statistics and your first half highlights, which has been a lot of Pioneers. They have forced a turnover. They have had good special teams play. Everything has been good there. And it's a Pioneer defense that has really just handcuffed this Shorter offense until this drive. The first drive, they kind of got a match or a feel for the speed of play. And since then, they have been, the Hawks have been grounded.
The Hawks do have 1 minute, 21 seconds to get the ball down the field and try to put some points on the board before going into the locker room.
So this will be a play action. Pass into the flat will be complete. It was a long throw for a minimal gain of about 3, maybe 4 yards. And that pass will be complete to Cartez Carr, the senior from Odenville, Alabama. Of course, there's a 22 that plays defense as well, Aaron Jordan. I may have called him Aaron Jordan at one point in the game.
Well, I mean, that was a well-designed play by Shorter. They had the wide receiver, and the way they're lining up now, finally we get the Pioneer defense to look over and recognize that there's somebody standing over there.
And they put the ball on the left hash. The ball should have been spotted on the right hash. Tusculum thought they called a timeout. That's not the case. The ball just should have been spotted on the right. I don't know why it was moved to the left hash.
No, because whenever you run out of bounds on your own sideline, you don't bring the ball over to the other team's sideline, put it in play.
1:15 on the clock. Tusculum leading 20-0. Second down and 7. Pullum to pass. He's under pressure in the backfield. He avoids two tacklers. There's going to be a flag on the play as Pullum will take it inside the 40 to the 38-yard line. He is caught by Devin Woodson, again, who had 6 tackles last week in the North Greenville loss, catching the quarterback trying to get away. And, of course, Woodson, I think, more upset that he didn't make this tackle in the backfield. There's probably a reason. He was the one that was being held in the backfield.
Yeah, I think any way you look at it, that's got to be a holding penalty against Shorter.
Again, Pullum just running for his life, just a sophomore. Last week, things were a little bit easier for him. 19 of 28, completing 68% of his passes last week. Today, 6 for 12. That's not bad. That's not terrible. 57 yards, but the second down run negated on the hold. So 1 minute to play until the half. Trips to the near side for the Hawks. Pull him out of the gun. Play action, looking, pumping, throwing, completing at the 40-yard line, and taking a knee on the catch was Carr, and that's where the play will be stopped. It'll be third down and about 4, and Shorter will burn their second timeout of the half. So we'll take it as well and return in 30 seconds to Pioneer Field. Tusculum leading Shorter 20-0.
Trouble keeping track of your medications and when you should have.
Only one chance to make that first impression. Don't worry, this might be new for you, but Ingles has been there before. From flowers to the freshest ingredients, we have everything you need to put your best foot forward.
I'm so sorry.
Remember, you can't get to happily ever after without once upon a time. Ingles, all the ingredients for family.
So third down four out of the timeout by Shorter. They have one remaining, 45 seconds to play. They were not afraid to go for it on fourth down in their opening drive in their own possession, in their own field, side of the field where they converted. So if they don't pick it up here, you know what will probably be coming. This pass will be complete inside the 20 and down to the 15. Pullum took a hit after the throw and likely will be a penalty against the Pioneers, but a big play by the Hawks. Joseph Ross just went up, climbed the ladder with two defenders on him, and Pullum put it in the perfect spot.
Yeah, and that's going to be tacked on at the end of the play, I'm suspecting, so it'll be half the distance to the goal. Spot the ball at about the 7.5 for Shorter once this gets marked off.
Jerry Odom, what I like about him when you have the personal fouls or the late hits, those types of things, he calls them just selfish. He says, guys, you gotta be smarter than that and not to put yourself in these situations. So you give the Hawks a chance to get back into this game right here with a score, and you've gone half the distance inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
39.2 seconds, and the Hawks still have one timeout to burn.
Max Melton had to go back and pick up his flag and now get himself into position. So he holds up Pullum for just a second. Wilgren Ford in the backfield. Four carries for 6 yards last week. Already a carry for 13 yards today. Pullum to the back of the end zone and tiptoeing. No. Incomplete anyway. Matt Simon defending. Looking for Ross. It looked like Noah's at Hayes. It'll be incomplete. It'll bring up second and goal at the 7.
Burn 10 seconds off the clock. 29.5 with the clock stopped here because of the ball being out of bounds.
Great throw by Pullum, though. Only Hayes was going to be there to catch it, even though Matt Simon was draped all over Lewis Hayes. It was incomplete. So Hayes, the punter as well, been the top target today of Pullum, and why not? He had 7 catches last week for the Hawks. So here on a second down and goal from the 7, Pullum to pass. Looking, pass will be complete. A great route. Touchdown Shorter as the Hawks get into the end zone. That'll be Elijah Gilbert, the sophomore out of Margate, Florida. And from 7 yards, he ran a little out and then in, and it was a great pass by Pullum, and the Hawks are on the board.
Gilbert had 3 catches for only 38 yards last week, his first touchdown of the season.
So Shorter on to attempt the point after. Brady Hamill with 24 seconds to play. Snap, hold, kick is up, and it's doinked off the upright, missing right. Well, Shorter's into the end zone, but they still trail by 14. We go to a break, 24 seconds to play. It's Tusculum 20, Shorter 6. Pioneer football continues after this on the Pioneer Sports Network. The Tusculum experience is 20 sports, one team striving for excellence. The Tusculum experience offers state-of-the-art facilities for practice and game days. If you seek a championship atmosphere, the Tusculum experience is for you. Visit online through TusculumPioneers.com. Call 423-636-7300 to discover the Pioneer experience for yourself.
Deal.com. Homeownership is the foundation of the American dream. It is a significant milestone in your life and is an important financial investment. Realty Executives has years of experience in helping homebuyers and investors purchase real estate in East Tennessee. We have a strong commitment to our clients and work hard to form trusting relationships. If it is time for you to make a change, then call Realty Executives at 423-639-3465 and let us guide you home.
This is Tusculum College Football on WSMG with the voice of the Pioneers, Brian Satan.
Lewis to kick it away. Martez Tompkins can't get there to field as it goes into the end zone, and really Shorter caught a break. They were 3 yards off sides before Lewis kicked the ball. So the Pioneers will have it first and 10 from their own 25 with 24 seconds to play. We'll see how Jerry Odom plays this out. You will receive the second half kickoff as well. You lead it 20-6.
You know, that's one of those calls where if you wanted to throw the penalty for being offsides on a kickoff, you could do it every single kickoff. Yeah. But that, I mean, there's daylight there, so yeah, might have liked to see the penalty flag thrown right there.
Yeah, it was quite a bit of daylight there, I believe. Lorenzo Pratt will be in the backfield for the Pioneers. Ogle comes under center, two wide outs, max protection. This will be Pratt right up the middle. He's got a convoy of blockers. Pratt cuts it up at the 40 and takes it to the 44-yard line as he'll gain 19 yards on the play. And the Pioneers, I think, will burn one of their final two timeouts they have here.
They did. I don't think it's a real effort to have to set up strategy as much as it is to make sure everybody is on the same page and keep the clock stopped so they get the maximum 17.9 seconds.
Well, for the Shorter Hawks, let's give you their second best drive of the game. Their first drive of the game was pretty good, just didn't yield any points. 9 plays, 75 yards, 3 minutes and 2 seconds off the clock. Elijah Gilbert, a 7-yard pass from Tyler Pullum. Brady Hamill kick was no good as it was pushed off to the right. Joe and I kind of had a little chuckle. The ball, it's almost like he shanked a sandwich because he chunked that thing. It was slowly moving toward the upright, and it stoinked off of the upright. I was going to give it a doink. It wasn't a stoink. A stoink is a miss from distance off the upright. A doink is a chip shot. That's your Terry's Flooring scoring, plus my own opinion. Recap.
On Monday, I was over here at Tusculum College speaking to a class of some future teachers, we hope. And I got asked about my involvement with the Pioneers, and they asked me about my greatest memory. I said, I don't know if it was greatest memory, but I still remember Gareth Rowlands.
Yeah,
that's my most vivid memory.
First and 10. Play action pass, Ogle looking across the middle for Cruel. One-handed grab is taken in at the 37-yard line. Highlight reel catch by Rodnell Cruel as they quickly get to the line.
Pioneers doing an excellent job to sell that play with Ogle, and now he spikes it.
That was a Todd Cunningham play. There's a name from the past, Todd Cunningham.
Yeah, Presbyterian, a long time ago.
I remember Todd Cunningham, Caleb Slover, those two guys with duels and battles, and Cunningham was the best, what do you call him, the hider of the football, protector of the football?
Yeah, concealer.
Concealer of the football. After a play action fake, he would actually sit there, and I thought that the running back had it, the entire team thought he did, because he could just sit there and somehow just cock his wrist away to hide the ball right on the numbers between his back. And he would just look at the play and allow DJ Humphreys. He wasn't the greatest receiver in the South Atlantic Conference this year for no reason. It was because he had a quarterback like Cunningham, no question about it. And the fact that he had some God-given ability. But Cunningham could hide the ball better than any quarterback I had seen. That was pretty good right there by Oak.
Absolutely. But you realize we're gradually getting into the point when we're talking about these players from Tusculum and conference past. They played before some of these Tusculum players were born.
Yeah, we were talking about that the other day, too. Talking about when I had gone to school and graduated, and they said, oh, that was the year I was born. First and 10 from the 37 for Ogle. He'll let this one fly to the sideline. There's two guys there, and one of them, Evan Gates, makes the catch at the 19. First and 10, Pioneers, 4 seconds. And I believe this will give Gallegos a chance to come out here and get some more points right before the half.
I think Pioneers are going to go with the higher percentage here, go for the field goal, because you've only got a chance at one play. They didn't want to risk trying to reach the touchdown.
So they don't have to rush because the clock won't start. So this one will be from 37. Gallegos is up, and Gallegos is good. And that will end the first half. as Gallegos hits three field goals in the first half in his first ever collegiate game. And the Tusculum Pioneers, where it appeared as if, well, then maybe we'll see how they play it out. Well, Joe, they were very aggressive how they played out the first half.
Just a matter of, what did they have, 29 seconds maybe?
25
seconds whenever they got the ball back to start this drive. Got 3 points on the board. So showing a lot of heart, showing a lot of guts, showing what they can do to excite these home fans.
So the Pioneers will go to the half with the lead, and we'll come back with your Pioneer Halftime Report with a look at this week in Tusculum Athletics and a look at your first half stats and your highlights. That's all when we return here to Pioneer Field. It's the home opener, and the Pioneers pleasing the home faithful. At the half, it's Tusculum 23. It's Shorter 6. Pioneer football continues after this on the Pioneer Sports Network.
I think that most of us...
The first date. Only one chance to make that first impression. Don't worry. This might be new for you, but Ingles has been there before. From flowers to the freshest ingredients, we have everything you need to put your best foot forward.
I'm so sorry.
Remember, you can't get to happily ever after without once upon a time.
Wow, funny running to
Ingles. Yeah. All the ingredients for family.
Now the band will play the number one hit by the Chainsmokers, Closer. Thank you. And that's the band that performed the Fits and the Tantrum set featured in the movie Despicable Me 3, in class. With coaches Jeff the Infor and Amber King, your 2017 Tusculum College Spirit Squad. Thank you.
Hey, Alan, I heard that having your prescription filled at one of those...
The first date. Only one chance to make that first impression. Don't worry. This might be new for you, but Ingles has been there before. From flowers to the freshest ingredients, we have everything you need to put your best foot forward.
I'm sorry.
Remember, you can't get to happily ever after without once upon a time.
Wow, funny running into
Ingles, all the ingredients for family. Where do you go when you want to save money on clothes?
You go to the outlets, right? And when you want to save money... Tusculum College is Tennessee's first college. Established in 1794, Tusculum's beautiful campus is nestled in the foothills of the Great Smoky Mountains, where students from all around the world have found a home. Tusculum can help you pioneer your path to success. Visit online for more information at tusculum.edu or call 423-636-7300 and discover the Pioneer Experience for yourself. The Tusculum Experience is 20 sports, one team, striving for excellence. The Tusculum Experience offers state-of-the-art facilities for practice and game days. If you seek a championship atmosphere, the Tusculum Experience is for you. Visit online through TusculumPioneers.com. Call 423-636-7300 to discover the Pioneer Experience for yourself. Tusculum leading here at the half, 23-6. We welcome you back into the halftime report. Time to take a look at your first half highlights, brought to you by your Greenville Light and Power System, serving Greenville and Greene County since 1945. Shorter would receive the opening kickoff, and actually they would drive, converting on fourth down. They would pin the Pioneers deep on their first drive, and the Pioneers, which that first drive would begin at the 11-yard line. A heavy dose of Maxwell Joseph, some Evan Altizer, and Evan Gates on that opening drive would yield a field goal by Isaac Gallegos from 37 yards away. With 3 minutes and 20 seconds on the clock, the Pioneers would lead in that first quarter by a score of 3-0. We move to the second quarter. Pioneers driving once again because they got great field position after a kickoff return of 32 yards by Evan Altizer. It would set up Maxwell Joseph from the 25-yard line. Maxwell Joseph, he'll start right, he'll stay right, 20. Maxwell Joseph, 10. Joseph at the 5, and Joseph into the end zone. Touchdown, Pioneers. Touchdown, Maxwell Joseph, as he touches Peter. Maxwell Joseph from 25 yards, his longest rush of the year to date, and the Pioneers with the point after by Gallegos would make it a 10-0 game. The Pioneers' defense would come in, pinning their ears back and causing all sorts of problems with the shorter offense, and again, giving the Pioneers some short field position in which to work. The Pioneers would start a drive in that middle of that second quarter, and they would drive the ball down the field, and they would get some big plays on that as well. Evan Altizer and Rodnell Cruel coming up with some big plays. Big plays for Altizer, a 19-yard reception and a 23-yard reception, eventually settling in at the 1-yard line, and Joseph would punch it in for his second touchdown of the day. Hand it off to Joseph. He will meet contact at the line of scrimmage and plow his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Tusculum. Touchdown, Maxwell Joseph, crossing pay dirt from a yard out. His second. Again, it would be all set up by that of Altizer and Cruel. 7 plays, 53 yards, 3:27 off the clock, and the Pioneers would take a 20-0 lead. But Shorter would get the ball back with just a few moments left in the first half, and all of a sudden, big plays started to happen for them. First with Ross on a long 24-yard reception. It all began with their backup running back coming in for 13 yards, converting 2 third downs on the drive, setting up a second down and goal from the 7 as Pullum would find Elijah Gilbert. Pass looking. Pass will be complete. A great route. Touchdown Shorter as the Hawks get into the end zone. Elijah Gilbert with the touchdown from 7 yards away from Tyler Pullum. The point after would be no good,
and the score would be 20-6. And with 24.9 seconds remaining in the first half, I should say 24.3 to be exact, the Pioneers would begin a drive, started off by Lorenzo Pratt, then Rodnell Krull, then Evan Gates, and then enough time for Gallegos to come in and kick his third field goal of the first half. This one would be good from 37 yards. Gallegos in his first collegiate game, good from 37, 25, and 37. And the Tusculum Pioneers take the lead into the locker room at 23-6. Reminds us of another kicker from the Knoxville area. Gallegos out of that Knoxville area for this Pioneer football team. As a freshman out of the CAK, the Christian Academy of Knoxville. The other guy was Welsh. I called him Welsish one time because I didn't understand what it was. I had to just go ask him. We'll have more on that as we get set to start the second half of action here from Pioneer Field. That's been a look at your first half highlights brought to you by your Greenville Light and Power System, serving Greenville and Greene County since 1945. Second half action is on the way. Stay tuned. We hope you have enjoyed the Pioneer Halftime Report. Now stay tuned for more Pioneer football. It's Tusculum 23 and Shorter 6. Pioneer football continues on the Pioneer Sports Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, stop into your
neighborhood. The first date. Only one chance to make that first impression. Don't worry. This might be new for you, but Ingles has been there before. From flowers to the freshest ingredients, we have everything you need to put your best foot forward.
I'm so sorry.
Remember, you can't get to happily ever after without once upon a time. Ingles, all the ingredients for family.
Tusculum College is Tennessee's first college. Established in 1794, Tusculum's beautiful campus is nestled in the foothills of the Great Smoky Mountains, where students from all around the world have found a home. Tusculum can help you pioneer your path to success. Visit online for more information at tusculum.edu or call 423-636-7300 and discover the Pioneer experience for yourself.
Of the Pioneers, Ryan Staten. Pioneer football.
And we welcome you back into Pioneer Field as we get set for the second half of action here at Tusculum. Just a reminder for you, next week the Pioneers will be on the road. It'll be on ESPN3 as well. We'll take on the Saints of Limestone at the house the NFL built down there at the reservation in Gaffney, South Carolina. Joe and I went and visited that last year. We thought, the high school? This is a high school field? I'm telling you, folks, it is the one of the best facilities the Pioneers play in all year. We'll have that coverage for you next week. Coverage at 6, kickoff at 7 o'clock. Shorter opens up conference play 2 next week. They travel to Florida Tech. Had a chance I always have a chance to catch up with Gareth Rollins as before we went to break. Lewis first to kick it away, and this will be Tompkins fielding it at the 1. At the 5, 10, stop and go at the 20, and will be taken down at the 22. So, real quick, Gareth Rollins, a coach of the local Greenville Galaxy. It's funny, a football player who finally they got this offsides penalty. Yeah. They finally got it right. But a soccer guy, of course, he's from Wales. We give him a hard time because probably the most dramatic kick of all time, maybe in the history of Pioneer football, rested on his right foot. And it was good. It was good for I think it was 57-yard attempt. We'll just go ahead and add some yards to it.
I don't think that's adding. If it is, it's only a couple. It was – he was kicking from – I'm pretty sure he was kicking from –
from Ken Sparks' side of the field.
Tusculum's, or, you know, side of the field.
And anyway, he stoinked it off the upright because he hit it with power and distance. But he hit the upright and nearly took it off of its bearings. Nearly took it off of the ground. He hit it so hard. And he missed it. It was their most dramatic, because it's Carson Newman. For
it is,
out
and
loud.
And if he would have missed it, it would have just not been a big deal and faded into memory. The fact that it was from that distance and it hit the upright, and it was the difference in the game, and we were both on our knees here in the press box.
Either way, he asked us to remind him of something that he made. The only thing I could think of that he made was a kick in high school against North Green. Martez Tompkins on a re-kick, a better return. We'll take it out to the 41-yard line. Of course, Gareth Rowland's out of King's Academy. We're not sure that the King's Academy has even opened the doors anymore, because we think he shut the doors when he left.
Unfortunately for Gareth, like many of us, that was a long time ago now. So
long time ago, my friend.
And we just made the comment earlier that some of these players that we were talking about in Tuscaloosa South Atlanta Conference history, that was before some of the current players were born.
Right. So we start this second half, by the way. Tusculum leading at 23-6. We'll get to some scores around the league. I don't know if we have some updates or not. Maxwell Joseph will start. We always like bringing up pioneers into our broadcast, former pioneers, and Gareth, one of those guys that I get to see quite often. And a great guy, going to be a great father, a great husband, and that's kind of what Pioneer Nation is about, and molding men for the future, and it's good to see him. And he's touching lives. The kids that he coaches in the Greenville Galaxy organization, they all love him. So doing the things that he was taught, being raised to do. Probably his parents, but we like to take some of that credit as well. Second down and 7 here after the Joseph carry. He'll get it again. The big man will spin off a couple of tackles and take it up to about the 45. Gain only a yard, bring up third down.
Brian, some of those other scores, as mentioned earlier, Carson Newman winner at home today, 41-14 over St. Augustine's. Catawba winning on the road, knocking off VMI 27-20. Newberry on the road at Virginia Union, going home with a 42-22 victory. Wingate in the second quarter, just ahead of Fayetteville State. Wingate on the road playing Fayetteville State, up 17-14. Mars Hill at North Carolina at North Carolina A&T, trailing 21-0.
Third down, 6. 13.5 just underway here in this third quarter. Pratt will go to the left shoulder now of Ogle out of the gun. Little play action, quick hitter, and it's too hot. Incomplete. It's intended for Rodnell Cruel, and he couldn't bring it in. The Pioneers, a quick 3-and-out, will punt it away to shorter. They cannot capitalize on some of that momentum.
Brian, one more game, actually two more games underway, one with a score. Lenore Ryan's at home hosting North Greenville. The Bears lead the Saints 7-6 early in the first quarter. And late in the first quarter, Limestone is home hosting Benedict, and that game is scoreless.
You say LR leads that game?
7-6, so.
Okay.
And it's just – it's not even halfway of the first quarter.
Hunter Cantrell will punt for the second time. This one very high. This one will not turn over, and it's muffed, but it's picked up by the returner. Actually, he actually asked for a fair catch, but he muffed it, picked it up, was hit. No flag because he had actually lost possession of the football. But it'll be first and 10 either way for the Hawks. They'll scrimmage from their own 13. Great punt by Hunter Cantrell.
That LR North Greenville score, without knowing, I'm just going to guess 7-6. That point in the first, they've each scored a touchdown. LR got their extra point, and North Greenville missed theirs. Would be my most likely guess.
Rob, gravely missed?
They might have hit two field goals, but I don't think that there's been a chance to have that many possessions at that time in the game.
Grief gravely. Like to have seen a miss last week. Oh, he did miss a couple, sorry. So on first and 10, handoff, McCoy, not much. Maybe the 14. The Pioneers, Colton Strickland on that defensive line. They are clogging up. Not much running room for McCoy, who ran well against Mars Hill last week. He is not running well against this Pioneer defense. A defense, not surprising, a little ahead of the offense at this point of the year, but Jerry Odom taking over more of the defensive play calling there as well.
Right, and the offense is the one where, especially the timing between your quarterbacks and receivers, that just takes game experience to get that timing down pat.
So it will bring up a second down and 9 from the 14 for the Hawks. They go right to left on your radio, and just not much running room in the backfield. I think it was – I was actually going to think that was Lakeith Brown, but it wasn't. It was Richard Gravel, a young freshman that we're going to be talking about a lot more. He's got all sorts of speed. Here's a guy that will be a track guy that ran a 100 – 10.9, something like that. And Jerry says, I don't care if he doesn't understand the concepts just yet. The guy's got all sorts of speed. He's got to be out there.
Yeah, Pioneers need him.
You have an injured Hawk on the play as well. And that will slow some things up with the Pioneers leading here 23-6 in their home opener. And was it cool outside when you went out there?
It was actually warmer outside than it is in here. That's why I took my jacket off to go outside.
I was getting ready to say, you know, it's still only about 70, 75 degrees outside. Can we get we need a sponsor for our time, down, distance, and temperature.
We're going to call it officially 69 according to my watch.
So it's got to be 47 degrees in this booth. Because there is not enough. I don't have enough clothing to keep myself warm. On the carry, starting the second half, is Weldron Ford, the young freshman from Opelika, Alabama. So he got the start here in the second half, and it was not McCoy. So we have not seen much of McCoy since that opening drive, and I'm not sure if that's by design or wasn't getting the job done, but I still don't see him out there as well. So it's going to bring up third down and 8. As Ford will walk off the field under his own power.
We had a blood drive at school on Wednesday, and after I donated blood for the rest of the day, I was as cold as could be. But it is well worth it because West Green won the annual blood drive battle against South Green, so go Buffs.
Won the game last night as well. Pioneers, they call this the prowl. They're just going to bring everybody. Pullum picks up on it. He delivers the pass, which will be complete, and there is going to be possibly a shove. At least D. Alford thinks it's going to be a shove and an offensive pass interference. There is a flag down, but let's just not take anything away from a tremendous catch by Joseph Ross.
Yeah, it was. It was a great catch, and Coach Odom saying backing it up. I don't know where the shove was, if it was against Shorter, Max Melton's asking Coach Odom what he wants to do, but I don't know how he shoved anybody just from the positions of the players.
I don't know if you want to ask after you just picked up 27 yards. Do you want to accept the penalty or decline?
Yeah,
I think we'll accept. Offensive pass interference is going to be the call. I don't know if you can pick the sarcasm in my tone there, but I was laying it on pretty thick. Back inside the 10.
Number 18.
Hey, a great catch by Ross. He did get just a little bit of a shove. Alford was in good position, but I still think that Ross was going to make that catch. It was one of those sideline back shoulder catches, and I don't really even think Ross had to shove. But when you extend the arms, that's what gets caught each time. If you can do that professionally and just kind of do a quick shove without extending the arms, usually you get away with it. So third and long, they'll run a draw, and the Pioneers are ready for it, and they are going to swarm the carrier. On the carry is going to be Aaron Bryant, it would appear. And again, tough to pick up those numbers, but it is Bryant who will not pick up maybe just a yard. Good at pressure by this Pioneer defense.
And another thing, Keith Brown leading the way.
Yeah, and Lakeith is, he's got all sorts of speed to burn. Thing that we have noticed about this Pioneer defense, they're starting to get it. They're picking up, reading their keys properly, and when they read it, then they just fly to the football. Fourth down, 17. Hayes to punt. This one, a spiral that turns over. It'll drive Altizer back to the 50. He'll get a block, 40. Altizer, 30. Altizer to the 25-yard line. Evan Altizer with a 25-yard return, and the Pioneers in great field position after a punt of 42 yards.
Excellent job there by the defense to back Shorter up, force him to punt back from back deep. Great job by Evan Altizer, and then he got a couple good blocks to really get into the clear.
Pioneer football team that leading at 23-6. They went 3-and-out on their opening possession. I'm just kind of moving around, just trying to warm up. You said it earlier, you can hang meat here in this room. Yes. My nose is starting to run. From the 25, first and 10. Ogle comes under center. Maxwell Joseph in the backfield. Back to pass will be Ogle with some time. He'll go deep for Cruel into the end zone. Can't hang on to it. Had it in his hands, couldn't bring it in. He may have been dislodged. It was a good hit by the free safety who was just playing center field back there, Kevin Knight. Just knocked it away from Cruel at the last second. Second down and 10. Couldn't have been a better pass by Alex Ogle.
It was a great pass by Ogle. It was into double coverage and just a good defensive play by Knight, as you say. Correll trying to make a play, and he nearly did. It was just an overall good football play by both sides of the ball.
So second down and 10, maybe the added fact for the Pioneers with their kicker in Gallegos. Go ahead and let that one go. Maxwell Joseph with the handoff. He'll take it across the 20 and down to the 15-yard line. I wasn't sure that Ogle was going to get the exchange there because it appeared as if he was trying to follow Ogle into the hole because he didn't give it to him.
And we're talking about the temperature. It is unseasonably cool right now. It's usually not quite this cool at 1st of November. And just probably don't even need to air on in here. Let's go natural.
Well, it would be better if we just had a window we could open. That would warm things up. First down and 10 from the 15. Handoff, Maxwell Joseph up the middle. My goodness, when he delivers a blow, he delivers. He does not fall backwards. Maxwell Joseph falls forward, and he'll take it down inside the 10 to the 7, gaining 8 yards on the play.
Maxwell Joseph, the ball carrier, whenever contact is made, it's usually the defensive player that goes backwards and not the Pioneers.
But Austin Porter that time went backwards. So second down and 2 from the 7. We go under 10 minutes to play here in this third quarter. Pioneers leading 23-6. Shaq Harris will come to the near side along with Connor Johnston. Shorter will adjust defensively as well, and they will run to the weak side. Maxwell Joseph stumbles, gets the first down, and on into the end zone. Maxwell Joseph's third touchdown of the game, and the Pioneers extend the lead.
And just an big explosive run by Maxwell Joseph. Again, offensive line beginning to look good now, getting some blocking on that left-hand side and allowed him to get into the end zone.
Well, the Pioneer athletic department will host a fireworks night tonight when the game is over with, but I don't know how many fireworks they're going to have left.
Hey, that's a good problem to have. Run and get some more. We can't have too many fireworks.
Did talk about wanting to have fireworks during the game and definitely providing that. Maxwell Joseph into the end zone once again. Just a bruising running back. Snap, hold, kick by Gallegos is up and good. And the Pioneers add to their lead. We go to a break, 9:30 to play here in the third quarter. It's Tusculum 30 and Shorter 6. Pioneer football continues after this from Pioneer Field on the Pioneer Sports Network. The Tusculum experience is 20 sports, one team striving for excellence. The Tusculum experience offers state-of-the-art facilities for practice and game days. If you seek a championship atmosphere, the Tusculum experience is for you. Visit online through TusculumPioneers.com. Call 423-636-7300 to discover the Pioneer experience for yourself. Laughlin Memorial
Hospital. Whatever you do, do it well.
All right, Popsy. We're going to figure out how to break that law. I'm going to think of a special word, and you.
Returner on the play, Barnett Bailey. Great return on special teams for the Hawks. They'll have it near midfield when they start down 30-6.
Yeah, I mean, that was a return of, we'll call it right about 42 yards, yeah. Maybe. Just an excellent return by him. Getting seams, got some blocking, and came across the field to get where he is.
I'm going to give him the 44-yard line, so we'll call it officially 39 yards. On that return, Maxwell Joseph into the end zone for his third scoring touchdown of the night. All three touchdowns by the Pioneers have come from the ground. Ogle does not have a passing touchdown in the game. He's passed it effectively. There is a penalty flag on the far sideline after this running play, gaining a yard to the 45. And right in the middle of that was Quaheem Glasgow, the young sophomore out of Newberry, South Carolina. We just plucked him away from the Wolves. And we'll check the flag.
You know, it's probably going to be some sort of holding against the Pioneers, but had absolutely zero to do with the play.
Or it's just some maybe extracurricular that has gone on, or a sideline warning, maybe that one of the coaches was on the field when the play happened. That could have been a situation.
Stay down.
Yeah, we're going to say, you know what, don't throw your flag for something that has no bearing to the play.
Yeah, whenever it's 50-plus yards away from the run, we're just going to go ahead and let that go.
Let's give you the Terry's Flooring scoring recap as we can now. Four plays, 25 yards, all of it Maxwell Joseph on the ground, and he finishes it off with a 7-yard touchdown run. He had runs of 10, 8, and 7 to get into the end zone for the Pioneers. The point after by Gallegos makes it 30-7. Your Terry's Flooring scoring recap. This pass will be incomplete. Coverage was extremely good, blanketed type coverage. And this time Martez Tompkins is going to sit there and say, yeah, he's looking like he's not guilty, but when you have a hold of the receiver as you are backpedaling, fearing as if you have been burnt, you have probably drawn the ire of the official. That is the case.
It's
going to be an automatic first down from a spot there. Take the ball over midfield into Tuscum territory at about the 41.
Now, look, Shorter had a good day last week offensively. I'm just going to say they churned up 322 yards of offense against Mars Hill, but they did it primarily between 20-20. They just could not finish. They couldn't capitalize. Couldn't score field goals. They went for it on fourth down. They weren't very good when they got inside the red zone as it is. They haven't moved it like that here tonight. Well, back into the football game and running it right up the middle for the Shorter Hawks. And that is Weldron Ford. Good to see him back in. He left a bit banged up earlier. Now, who we have not seen back into the game is B.J. McCoy. We don't know if that is by design and by injury or what coach's decision or what it is, maybe just not running hard enough. Either way, Ford has gotten the bulk of the carries since about their fourth drive of the first half.
Right now, Shorter looking to go. They're spreading heavy on their right side, probably looking to go deep.
So on second down and 10 from the Pioneer 41, pull him to pass. He's got time. And now the pocket breaks, and he starts to scramble. Looking downfield, has a man who has finally come open. Hayes complete across the 30 and down to the 29-yard line. That'll move the chains. First and 10 on a pickup of 13.
Not as deep as Shorter wanted to go because of the pressure by the Pioneer defense, but deep enough to get a first down for the Hawks.
First down, Shorter.
So first down and a 10. For Shorter, bring in a blocking back in the backfield. Try to get this running game going, and this will be Ulysses Carswell, senior from Dorian, Georgia. He is in the backfield, and they'll run some type of an option, and this is going to be Ford around the right edge. He'll break a tackle right at the line of scrimmage and take it inside the 20 and down to about the 17-yard line. So he'll pick up 12 more yards here, and Ford has just been the more effective runner in the game for the Hawks.
Well, and switching to that option was certainly a strange look that the Pioneers weren't prepared for. Haven't seen that all game, and whenever you do, it picks up big results for you.
Pioneers lead it right now 30-6 as we go to 7 minutes to play here in this third quarter. Two wideouts to the far side, two to the near side. Ford stays in the backfield with Pullum, who is working from the gun. He'll send a man in motion across the formation. Pullum to pass, looking left, now looking back across the middle, and the pass will be complete, breaking tackles at the 16-yard line. The ball has come free, and right now it is who is the strongest man on the bottom of that pile. Pioneers think, Lakeith Brown at least thinks, that they have it. Martez Tompkins coming out of there saying that the Pioneers have it. And D. Alford has it. And guess what? He's clad in orange and black. Pioneers take over. Second turnover of the game.
Jay Boyd coming out of the pile. And he still doesn't even have on his helmet. I don't know. I guess somebody else picked it up. But Jay Boyd making his way over here to the sidelines. Looks like he's maybe holding the bridge of his nose.
Yeah, he's got a gash. So he's got his helmet in his hand right now. But J-Boy lost it, but the Pioneers gain it. And a positive drive for the Shorter Hawks ends in a turnover. And now the Pioneers take over first and 10 from their own 16-yard line.
Having to reset the play clock once again.
Like I said, I don't know if it's operator error or if it's mechanical error. Either way, there's an error.
Mm-hmm.
So the Pioneers with two backs in the backfield. Tommy Brown is into the game. Will Boney is back there as well. Ogle is back to pass, and he's going to air it out. Looking to go deep and caught at the 40-yard line. The Pioneers, they continue to shell out these youngsters, but that's not a youngster. That's a young man that has been here a while. Chavis Williams from just across the mountain in Asheville with a big play for the Pioneers.
Big play for the Pioneers. Solid and composed. When you've got a quarterback like Ogle, he can just look down the field, and he knows where to throw it, and he throws it well. And then you get these wide receivers that can make plays in coverage. Good things are on the horizon here, I think.
First down and 10 for the Pioneers from the shorter 41-yard line, getting them out of deep in their own territory. Pioneers will put the ball on the ground at the 40, or say put the ball on the ground. They will run the football. And Tusculum, I believe that is Tommy Brown. Brown, the sophomore out of Jacksonville, Florida, will carry it for about 4. It'll bring up second down and 6.
He ran about 30 to get the 4. He just kept trying to go a little bit farther outside, a little bit farther outside, a little bit farther outside, trying to hit a corner but couldn't find it because Shorter just kept bringing people.
5:40 on the clock, set up here on the Chavis Williams catch over the shoulder from 43 yards from Alex Ogle. After the turnover by Hayes of Shorter, second down and 6. Ogle to pass again, looking incomplete. I believe that's Connor Johnston. There is a flag that is thrown late on the play as the pass intended for Connor Johnston, the sophomore from Warner Robins, Georgia. And we've got unsportsmanlike going against Shorter, so things getting a little bit chippy for the Hawks, who, again, riding an 18-game losing streak coming into tonight.
Yeah, and that's why I was looking at their schedule. It's what Shorter really needs to do is focus on the games they can win, because we mentioned the Gulf South. I mean, take a look at Delta State. That'll be an uphill challenge for them. North Alabama, obviously an uphill challenge. Mm-hmm. West Georgia, Valdosta State, probably not much chance right there. But, you know, Florida Tech, maybe West Alabama, Tough game, but perhaps one you could pick off. Mississippi College right there. These are the games you need to focus on getting better, so the games that you have a legitimate shot to win, and you can maybe pick up that W and bust the streak.
No question about that. This is a Pioneer football team, though, that's right now rolling. Their defense is rolling. Offense seems to be doing the right thing. Shaq Harris will line up on the left. Johnston to the right. Tommy Brown is the single running back. He'll get the carry, and he is not going to avoid the clutches of the rush, which came right up the middle by Justin Fillmore, the 6'2 junior, to bring up a second down and 12 back at the 25.
Yeah, whatever the read was there, Shorter certainly knew where the ball was going and unfortunately met Tommy Brown right about the point of impact and took him backwards.
I think part of the game plan, what Brian Ferguson runs and implements in his offense, is as a running back, you're going to have to make one guy miss. And if you do that, then you're going to have lanes. I know as an offensive lineman in the NFL, Brian Ferguson isn't thinking that. He's thinking we should block everybody. But I also believe he thinks that their running game, this is the fourth running back we've seen in the game already, as Jordan Shippey is in now. This pass is going to be tipped, and it's going to be incomplete. But I know what he's thinking. He's thinking that we're good enough, quick enough, fast enough. You got to make that guy miss. Shorter has some athletic players. When they get there, they bring it.
Yeah, I mean, they've got good players. It's a matter of, these guys have not been playing Division II college football very long.
Right.
So they're still trying to find themselves, find their identity. And once again, going into that tough Gulf South Conference, probably not the best thing for the development of their program.
Pass was intended for Deshaun Davis. He burst onto the scene last year for the Pioneers, a junior from Rock Hill, South Carolina. So Ogle now facing third down and 13. Five-step drop under center. Lets it fly for Shaq Harris, and somehow he makes the catch. Harris with it at the 10-yard line, and the entire team trying to bring him down, and they still can't bring him down. It'll be first and 10 for the Pioneers. We've been waiting for Shaq Harris to get involved in the offense. And Shaq Harris, hello, welcome to the game.
We're talking about the Gulf South, right? The Gulf South, what now, about 5 years ago, 6 years ago, fractured in two, and so that conference was forced to bring in a bunch of new teams,
right,
because they had a bunch of teams in the Arkansas and Louisiana type area out in there, some in Oklahoma, I don't know about Oklahoma, but that area that fractured off and formed a brand new conference and really took their numbers down and had to find some new members.
First and goal. Ogle from the 10, going to lob it into the corner of the end zone. It'll be incomplete. This could be offensive pass interference. There is a flag in the corner of the end zone as Torrey Ponder was the intended target. And he probably did a pretty good job there in pulling down the defensive back who had a better read on that particular ball.
And if you want to lay the praise or the blame on it, and anyone for the fracture of the Gulf South Conference, hey, former Tusculum Sports Information Director Will Pruitt is the commissioner of the new league out there.
We'll blame him.
We'll blame Will.
Little Debbie. If you want anything done, all you had to do is bribe him with the Little Debbie. Boy, that's back. That's a long time ago, too. There probably weren't many of these guys that were born when Will Pruitt was the SID here.
Mm-hmm.
97, 98.
Yeah.
So it's first down and goal from the 25 now for the Pioneers after the offensive pass interference. Tusculum leading 30-6. Ogle pats it twice, and this time he's off target, intended for Altizer to bring up second down and goal. And I listened to Jerry Odom this week talk about, you know, we've got to make the quarterback pat the ball. We've got to make him move from the spot. You could probably pretty much say that about every quarterback in America. If you get them uncomfortable, they're going to airmail it. And Ogle airmailed that one.
Yeah, it's just shorter, continuing, you know, as the game goes on, to figure out ways to put pressure on Ogle and cause him to make a bad pass.
Second and goal at the 25-yard line. The Pioneers lead 30-6. Hand off to Shippey, a little cutback, and he'll take it down to about the 20-yard line. Shorter trying to rip the ball from his person. They could not do so. He'll gain five. It'll bring up third and goal from the 20-yard line.
I was actually just sitting here right now looking over to down markers trying to remember how far did the Pioneers go before that penalty and everything to get backed up, but it is third and goal from their own 20-yard line.
They had it at the 10, then the 15-yard pass interference offensive penalty. Pioneers averaging 9.5 yards a play today. That's an explosive offense. Had some big plays. Playing exciting style, playing a shorter team that's lost 18 games in a row. Back to pass, and Ogle's in trouble. He's going to let it fly, and this one will be incomplete. Something happened up front. I'm not sure what happened with the offensive line, but definitely something happened up front. And this is going to give us a chance to meet our new hero for this week, and this is Isaac Gallegos. He'll be attempting his career-long field goal. Of course, everything that he has attempted has been a career for him. This one will just be a 38-yard attempt, 1 yard longer than his two previous makes from 37. O'Grady to snap it, Cantrell to hold it. Snap, hold, kick by Gallegos. This one is up, and this one is true. Gallegos, 4 for 4 from the spot at a new career best of 38 yards. We go to a break with your new score. 2:54 to play here in the third quarter. Tusculum 33 and Shorter 6. Pioneer football continues after this on the Pioneer Sports Network. Tusculum College is Tennessee's first college. Established in 1794, Tusculum's beautiful campus is nestled in the foothills of the Great Smoky Mountains, where students from all around the world have found a home. Tusculum can help you pioneer your path to success. Visit online for more information at tusculum.edu or call 423-636-7300 and discover the Pioneer experience for yourself.
Social groups and organizations in our local communities know that when it comes to their specific financial needs, they can count on us to help them.
We take pride in the accomplishments of these many groups who have helped our communities grow. Greenville Federal Bank, member FDIC. Banking made easy.
You're listening to South Atlantic Conference Football on WSMG with Brian Staten and
Tusculum Pioneers lead it 33-6. Gabe Schillings will be out to attempt the kickoff. After the 38-yard make, Schillings goes out of bounds at the 1. So Shorter will take over from the 35. And Schillings, who has put it deep in the end zone, and going from left to right on your radio dial, has done a nice job in kicking it deep. This one, however, just goes out of bounds.
Tuscum scoring kicker, Isaac Gaios. I'll tell you what, Brian, I'd walk down to the field at halftime as he was coming back out. You can't describe how huge a smile on that young man's face was. You know, happy with his first opportunity to get out here and be a pioneer and be a college football player. I was watching him as he came off the field, and it was a little bit bigger.
Yeah, I'd say so. So the Pioneers, more points on the board. And this comes after the Shorter Hawks fumbled it at the 16 of Tusculum. And then the Pioneers just took over. The big play was the Chavis Williams 43-yard catch, which took it to the 41. And then a couple of other pass completions, a couple of runs. And the Pioneers then had to settle after a pass interference after they took the ball down to the 10 for the 38-yard field goal, which was good by Isaac Gallegos, his fourth of the game. 9 plays, 64 yards, 6:25 off of the clock. The new look Pioneer team that takes time off the clock when they have that lead, trying to shorten the game as much as they can with this big time running game that they have, led by Maxwell Joseph. And that's your Terry's Flooring scoring recap. So second down and 10 after the play goes for nothing. On the running attempt, Pullum is in trouble and taken down at the 18-yard line. Just too much speed by this Pioneer defense, and Pullum has been running much of the game.
On the sack for the Pioneers, number 42.
And again, Richard Gervell, the freshman out of Fort Myers, Florida, which is dealing with a lot of situations right now because of Irma, comes up with that sack, and a young man that just all sorts of speed. Love what Jerry Odom had to say about him. He just said, look, I don't know that he's not picked up on the game just yet. He is going to be an impact player. He's been an impact player today. Third down, 25. Ball back at the 20. This will be a draw right up the middle. 25, 30, and up to the 34-yard line. It'll be fourth down and 11 for the Shorter Hawks. And the draw has worked a couple of times, but it has only worked because it has usually been third and long yardage.
I'd like to point out what is working for the Tusculum Pioneers, and that is Isaac Gallegos and Maxwell Joseph. Thanks to Nathan back at the studio, game station producer, he pointed out all 33 points for the Pioneers scored by those two players.
Guys, yeah. Big game for those guys. Hayes has had a big game in punting. He'll punt it again, sixth time. This one a wobbly spiral. Altizer's had a field day returning kicks. He stays on his feet at the 38, 40, and up to the 42-yard line. This time he was hemmed in on that far sideline, and it's getting a little bit more chippy on the field.
Yeah, the Pioneers do not need to do anything to get someone disqualified going into Limestone next week, because today's game seems well at hand. 33-6, 50 seconds left in the third quarter. Next week, open South Atlanta Conference play, so you want all your pieces in place.
So this Pioneer team will open up conference play. Yes, Limestone, an associate football member. A conference game next week for the Pioneers. Limestone playing Benedict today. Opened up the season with East Tennessee State University as they opened up their new stadium. Ogle stays in there, delivers a pass far sideline, which is complete. On the catch, Chavis Williams from across midfield to the Shorter 47-yard line. It'll move the chains, first and 10 for the Pioneers.
Pioneers perhaps getting in some practice on moving the chains and stopping the clock, because that was just a textbook play from your quarterback, catch the ball and step out of bounds.
For Ogle, Maxwell Joseph is out there in the backfield. Two wide outs to this near sideline, one to the far. Johnston, the tight end, to the near sideline. Toss it to Joseph. He takes a hit in the backfield, but he doesn't go backwards. He still gains about a yard, and he was hit a yard behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be second down and nine.
And that will be the last play of the third quarter.
So we will go to the fourth as the Pioneers looking to win their first of the year. It's also the home opener for this Tusculum Pioneer team. We will go to the fourth quarter, Tusculum leading big. It's Tusculum 33, it's Shorter 6. Pioneer football continues after this on the Pioneers Sports Network.
So much of life these days is rushing around from one place to another. Sometimes you just want to enjoy the journey on the way to the destination. And part of what makes it a little more enjoyable is an appreciation for the folks who help you get there. At Ingles, we know that the people who send you on your way are the same ones who keep you coming back.
I think you should take it for a spin.
Are you serious? Ingles, all the ingredients for family. The first date. Only one chance to make that first impression. Don't worry. This might be new for you, but Ingles has been there before. From flowers to the freshest ingredients, we have everything you need to put your best foot forward.
I'm so sorry.
Remember, you can't get to happily ever after without once upon a time.
Wow, funny running into
Ingles, all the ingredients for family.
Deal.com.
This is Tusculum College Football on WSMG with the voice of the Pioneers, Brian Satan.
Welcome back into Pioneer Field as we start the fourth quarter. A pass completion to Shaq Harris. Pioneers with 382 yards of offense, 151 for Shorter, and that's going to show up on the scoreboard as well. Tusculum leading at 33-6 and driving.
And like I say, this drive continued with a good play here on third down to move the chains one more time. But they got a little bit of work to do, Brian.
Joseph is the running back behind Ogle under center. Back to pass. Looking. Pass complete to Harris at the 35-30. And it takes four to bring him down at the 29-yard line. Moves the chains. First and 10 for the Pioneers.
And that's just a good, calm play by your quarterback and your wide receiver. Harris in danger, in trouble. Ogle throwing into triple coverage. And the Pioneers still making the catch, holding on to the football and moving the chains.
So Tusculum been good on third downs in the game as well. As we go a minute in here to this fourth quarter, Pioneers will adjust from one side to the next on the tight ends from right to left, and they'll run left. This will be Joseph running to daylight. Joseph at the 20, cuts back at the 10, down to the 6, first and goal for the Pioneers.
Scoring updates, Brian, as I already mentioned, Carson Newman, Catawba, and Newberry victorious today. Mars Hill is on the road at North Carolina A&T. Probably not going to pull this one out. North Carolina A&T leading 42-0 in the third quarter. Lenore Ryan actually leads North Greenville 19-7 just right before the halftime, and Benedict and Limestone are tied at 7 at the break.
Well, then, maybe Lenore Ryan's moving back to the cream of the crop, huh? Maxwell Joseph on the carry from the 6. Bounces off one tackler from the 5, and he'll take it down to the 1. May have lost the football. I did not see the beanbag come out. It's just tough to rip the ball away from him.
The beanbag did come out on the ground, and now they're trying to sort out who has the football.
Shorter thought that they had it. And the officials work it out. It's just who's stronger. You know who I'm going to go with? Maxwell Joseph. Max Melton puts number 2 in the air, which means it's second down and goal. This one will be from the 1-yard line. So it was a fumble. That's the second fumble of the game for the Pioneers. Of course, they haven't lost one.
Just judging by all the pats on the back, I want to think it might have been Caleb LaFleur that came out of there with the ball for the Pioneers.
Could have been. Former ETSU offensive lineman. Maxwell Joseph is over 100 yards, 19 carries, 118 yards. In the game. Despite the fumble, Joseph will stay in there because this is Maxwell time. Well, maybe not. Ogle will back out into the shotgun. And we've got a delay of really? We have a delay of game?
Delay of game.
I don't think that that wasn't.
I think that that was more problem with these down clocks.
Well, Tusculum is arguing it. They're not winning the argument.
Now, I guess the officials say, well, it's your field, your down clocks. If you think a shortage, you fix them.
One guy we have not talked about a lot tonight, Ogle has had pretty much a clean sheet. Kevion Broadwater has been inserted back into that offensive line, missed last week's game. Ogle will roll the pocket and throw into the end zone, incomplete. Good coverage by Knight as he covers up Keandre Banks, looking for his second touchdown of the year. It'll bring up a third down and goal back at the six.
You know, that, over the course of Pioneer Field being open here, we have seen some problems from time to time with the clocks and electronics, but it's usually following some sort of rainstorm, and we've not had that recently, so I'm going to think operator error somewhere along the lines.
Ogle on third down and goal from the six. Joseph in the backfield. They go under center and hand it off to Joseph, who doesn't find any daylight here. A couple of guys lose some headgear on the play. And it will bring up fourth down. I don't know if you kick another field goal here, you go for it. Fourth down and goal, leading 33-6.
Well, in this situation, it's one of those where if the Pioneers go for it, some folks might say, oh, you're trying to run up the score. But honestly, you're not. You're giving Shorter the opportunity to stop you. If you kick a field goal with a guy that's been pretty much automatic, mm-hmm. then you're running up the score already, leading 33-6 in the fourth quarter.
And I'd say if they hand it off here, that's the telltale sign. Just try and stop us. Ogle's going to come under center. On fourth and goal, he's going to pass it. Looking. Pass is tipped and incomplete. As the pass, I'm not sure that Gates would have gotten in. He tipped it at about the two-yard line. That was the intended target.
We do have a flag on the play.
And there is a flag on the play in the backfield. And, again, we talk about the chippiness, and it's going to go against Shorter. And it's an unsportsmanlike against Tusculum. All right, now, did Max change his mind?
Yeah, he changed his mind. Well, we're going to call it on the Shorter. So this should result in half the distance to the goal line and first down for the Pioneers.
So the line of scrimmage was the six, correct?
It was the six. So once this gets sorted, it should be first down and goal with the three for the Pioneers.
We'll see what Max says. Maybe it was going to be offsetting, and that would have said it's a do-over. Let's see what Max has to say.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct on the defense, number 93. Finley is half the distance to the goal. It'll be first down for Shorter.
Yeah.
It's the first unsportsmanlike conduct on number 93.
So it came after the play, which means it's a dead ball.
Dead ball, so it was half the distance, except Shorter does get the football.
Shorter will have the football. The defense will take over. As Shorter will have it first and 10 from their own 3-yard line, down 33-6 with 11:32 to play here in the football game.
It must have been some trash talk or something like that going on after the play.
So Ford will come out to be the running back. Pullum, who's just had a tough go of it today. 11 of 18, 115 yards, but he just hasn't had that time. He's got a pretty good percentage going once again, but he just hasn't had time to throw. He's been spending more time running. Ford running to the left, and he just is met by a wave of orange uniforms. And on that far sideline, and again, a little still very chippy as the guys get up off the bottom of that pile with some new faces, some new names. Kyle Bailey, a junior out of Decatur, Georgia, is out there. He was one of the first Pioneers to get there.
Another one of the Shorter players lost his helmet and had to come on. I realize they've not been playing that long, but they should have gotten a memo by now that if you lose your headgear during a play, you have to come off the field.
You have to come off. By the way, field looks great. I believe that the facilities did a great job getting the field ready for play here tonight in the home opener. Movement by Shorter, I believe. That's why they blew the play dead. Tomorrow, the Pioneer soccer team will be on this field. They'll play Lander tomorrow at 3 o'clock.
I was here Wednesday night to watch the Lady Pioneers play soccer, come out and get a victory in their game.
Tennessee Wesleyan, 2-1.
Yep.
They get a win. Then they have been canceled this weekend.
Supposed to be playing in Milledgeville, Georgia at a tournament down there, and it
didn't work out against Georgia College or Columbus State. They do play Columbus State. They are on the schedule, October 24th. Pullum to pass from his own end zone. We'll let it fly down the field, incomplete. And they're going to get a flag, and this is going to be with Martez, Tompkins, and Hayes. Tompkins, again, voicing his displeasure if it's going to go against him, because it looked as if Tompkins had pretty good position. You're taught from this defense in the secondary that when you turn into the receiver, which keeps you in play with the receiver. You understand where he is on the field when you turn to locate the ball, and I think that's all Tompkins did. But unfortunately, he's going to be whistled for his second pass interference of the game.
Whoever the penalties are against at this point now, 33-6 in the fourth quarter, put the penalty flags in your pocket and quit stopping the game.
Ten 10:43 to play here in the game. Slow to a snail's pace. Some youngsters are out there. Well, I say youngsters. This whole team is youngsters. Ford with the handoff, finding a little bit of daylight, as he'll take it across the 20 to the 21-yard line. He'll gain four to bring up a second down and six for Shorter.
Second down and six for the Hawks. Just trying to do something. If you get themselves feeling good after today's game and then after opening up the loss last week. Pioneers opening up the loss last week, but certainly going to be feeling good going into tonight.
Tonight against Shorter, next week against Limestone, then to Pembroke in 2 weeks before returning home. Second down and six. Chris Matthews, Patrick McGee, a youngster, a redshirt freshman, in on that last stop for the Pioneers. Pull him under center. It's four. Just trying to find a little bit of daylight as he is wrapped up right at the line of scrimmage by George Lira, the freshman out of Oakwood, Georgia. But he'll take it up across the 26. Will Ford. It'll bring up third down and a yard for the Shorter Hawks.
Taking a look at the rest of that Pioneer schedule, Brian. After the two road games, we're back home for 2 weeks against Lenoir Ryan and Mars Hill. Then at Newberry, home to Catawba, at Carson Newman at an unusual open date. Yeah. And then close out the season here against Wingate in November.
On third and a yard, this will be Ford, and he'll be hit by Matthews in the hole. But Ford, just like Maxwell Joseph, will take it up to the 30-yard line, move the chains for a first and 10.
First and 10, change moving. Clock continues to run. We're down to 9 minutes, 15 seconds left in the contest.
And again, Jerry Odom, as he said this week, I'm going to play a bunch of guys. You know, we're going to learn who all of these players are, but he is doing that. He is putting a bunch of players out there. James Sasser, one of the new faces, is out there. He's lined up in the hole on the defensive line on the right side. Pull him to pass, looking and throwing, and incomplete. It hit Hayes, and there is a flag on the play after the play. But Pullum, I don't know if he was going to – he fooled everybody. He even fooled his own receiver. He threw and hit him
– in the back.
In the back. And we've got an infraction, I think, going against Shorter. And again, they're losing their cool just a little bit here.
Well, this one's going to be an ineligible receiver downfield.
I just think it's a busted play. Right now we've got a busted broadcast for some reason. Stick around for downfield. Yeah, ineligible downfield. Stick around for our post-game coverage. That'll follow our fireworks, Joe, on the field with Jerry Odom. Joe and I will wrap this game up, and then I'll make my way down to the field after the fireworks display tonight. Wake up the neighborhood.
No, they're used to it. Living around here with the Astros.
Back to passes, pull them. Passes complete at the 30 to Hayes. Hayes to the 35 and taking it to the 36-yard line. First down and 15 becomes second down and about five. So a good pickup on after the penalty for Hayes. And Hayes has figured prominently in this entire game because he's also the punter, and he's done a good job doing that. But sometimes he's outkicked his coverage, and when – Evan Altizer has had a return, the Pioneers have usually scored. Actually, matter of fact, they have scored every time he's had a big return. So on second down, Pullum pulls it. He loses it. And was he able to fall back on top of it? As he was going down, the ball hit his knee and came free, but he was able to fall back on top of it at the 30-yard line, I think. The officials are going to talk about it and pull him.
But there's another penalty flag on the field too, Brian.
On that far sideline, and it's going to be an infraction against Shorter once again.
We mentioned the Greenville Astros. They won't be keeping the neighborhood up with fireworks any longer.
It won't be the Astros for sure.
Legal formation. On the
too many men or too few men on the line of scrimmage.
Third down.
Greenville Astros moving, I believe, to Fayetteville, North Carolina. Not too far away from Pembroke, where we'll be here in a couple weeks.
Yeah. So we go under 8 minutes to play here in the game. New quarterback is into the game as well, and welcome to the game. I'm not sure that... is that him? Kyron Priester, junior from St. Petersburg, Florida. And there's just not much running room there. And so it'll be fourth down. The punting team will be out.
Evan Altizer going out to field the punt, but you've got Jay Boyd back waving Altizer off, saying, no, I'm going to try this one.
Yeah, I got this.
I'm not sure if that was by design or not, but that's what's going to happen.
Hayes to punt it away. He'll punt it away from Boyd, who will field it and then fall to the ground, and then took a hit as he fell to the ground, lost his helmet. But it was a nice catch. The ball may have gone into the end zone, but Boyd went back, catches it above his head. There was a guy that used to play here that did that and would stay on his feet and return it. He was Ricardo Coakley. But this time, Jay Boyd fields it and then falls to the turf. It'll be first and 10. We see some new faces on that offense as they come out here leading 33-6, 7:08 to play. The answer is no. Alex Ogle will be back out there.
Oddly enough, Jay Boyd was one of the students I talked to here at campus on Monday.
Lorenzo Pratt will get the carry, running to the near side, and may have been taken down by Connor Johnston. Problem with the name that I've just called is Connor Johnston is his teammate, but Pratt tried to cut into him and helping out on that stop defensively for the Shorter Hawks was Austin Porter, and Austin Porter's had a good game defensively too.
It's going to be second down and 10. They rolled it no gain, Brian.
Pioneers leading 33-6. Breakout game tonight for Isaac Gallegos, kicker for the Pioneers. 237 yarders, 25-yarder, and a long of 38 tonight, 4 for 4. Back to pass will be Ogle across the middle. This one's going to be picked off. 35, 30, 20, 15, fumble recovered down at the 2-yard line. Rodney Jackson comes up with the interception, and it's the first interception of the year for Alex Ogle, and he threw it into coverage. And I know he wishes he had that one back because two receivers kind of turned their head as if the ball was thrown behind him, but it was thrown right to Jackson, who returns it to the 5, fumbled it, and then it's recovered by Shorter at the 3.
Pioneer still had a chance to prevent Shorter from getting football back. Didn't have anybody on the spot to recover the fumble, Brian.
So it is a first and goal for Shorter. They trail 33-6 with 6:12 to play. They will go with a power look, an old wishbone look, three guys straight across the back, an old Notre Dame-like look when Paul Horning played and won the Heisman. They'll give it to a big fullback, and he's still churning, and getting closer to that goal line. But coming up with that stop is going to be R.J. Brooks. He's wearing the jersey of Britt Hasty, who is still out dealing with the concussion protocol. And he comes up with that stop. It'll bring up second down and goal, the ball resting just shy of the 1-yard line.
Yeah, the Shorter picked up about a yard and a half on that play.
Under center, handoff again, and this time nothing. Well, the Pioneers were ready for that one. And the running back, still trying to pick out who it is. Yes, the hair is covering it.
The guy going off the field that lost his helmet.
So that's Anderson Joyner, the junior from Jonesboro, Georgia. And he'll have to go out of the game. So it's third down and goal after the interception. And they still got three guys in that backfield. And this time the quarterback straight ahead, and he's not going to get in. No, is he? Yeah. They're going to say that he did cross the goal line. Touchdown, Kyron Priester. Priester gets in from a yard away, if in fact that is Priester wearing number 10.
Well, these doubled-up jerseys, we kind of have to take a look. Offense, defense, and we'll say that's who scored a touchdown.
They're not really celebrated as if they score, but they did. Now are they going for two? I guess that's the question. Let's have some issues with their kicking game.
Trying to make the score 33-14. Put a few more points on the board.
So going for two are the Hawks. Ford is in the backfield with Priester. It's who will call him. They're going to lob it into the corner of the end zone, and it will be incomplete. Martez Tompkins defending on Hayes, and Tompkins a nice job at defensively. The two-point conversion fails, and we go to a commercial break. 5:17 to play here in the football game. Shorter will kick off when we return. It's Tusculum 33 and the Shorter Hawks 12. Pioneer football continues after this on the Pioneer Sports Network.
The Tusculum experience is 20 sports, one team striving for excellence. The Tusculum experience offers state-of-the-art facilities for practice and game days. If you seek a championship atmosphere, the Tusculum experience is for you. Visit online through TusculumPioneers.com. Call 423-636-7300 to discover the Pioneer experience for yourself.
And let us guide you home.
I think that most of us would agree that fall is the best time of year. I love it when the air cools down, the leaves start to change, and football season is here. From grade school to college, it's a great time for families and communities to come together to cheer on the favorite team. This is Alan Johnson from Marathon Quick Stops, wishing each player out there a great season. Give it 110%, but enjoy it. I know from experience that these are some of the best times of your life. Marathon Quick Stop, run in when you run out.
Pioneer football on WSMG with Brian Staten and...
Tusculum guarding against the onside kick. Jordan Shippey was back deep, but Hayes will kick it over his head. We have we understand that maybe it's Lewis Hayes who might be the quarterback now, although they haven't replaced the two-point conversion pass by Kyron Priester. But either way, I felt like if it is Priester who's wearing 10, he scored the touchdown, right? So...
But I will say for this, for the Pioneers, Brian, in the future, when you're guarding against the onside kick, do it with 11 players on the field.
They don't get that very often. Tommy Brown will get a carry, and he'll move it from the 25 up to about the 28, gain 3. It'll bring up a second down and 3.
And because they did only have 10.
Well, maybe they feel very confident in their hands team just to put those guys. They don't want anybody else out there.
Yeah,
to
we're getting in the way, so we're just going to get our hands guys up here.
Ogle will come under center. Two backs in the backfield for the Pioneers, Shippey and Brown. Ogle's going to turn around, hand this one off to Shippey. Makes one guy miss, but not going to make that third guy miss. And that third guy's had a big game tonight. He's playing free safety, or they've got him listed as a defensive back. But Kevin Knight has just had a big game defensively, deflecting passes, just taking the ball from would-be receivers, getting big hits to get the ball free. Rodnell Krull had a definite touchdown, and he comes up with a hit. So you've got Knight, who's had a big game. We've got an injured Shorter Hawk on the play as well.
Yeah, one of these guys taking out training staff coming on to give him a look-see.
So we'll have a look. We'll have a break as well. We'll step aside here from Pioneer Field during the injury timeout. 4:20 to play in the game. Pioneers lead Shorter 33-12.
Partner of Greenville Light and Power.
Did you know?
Tusculum College is Tennessee's first college. Established in 1794, Tusculum's beautiful campus is nestled in the foothills of the Great Smoky Mountains, where students from all around the world have found a home. Tusculum can help you pioneer your path to success. Visit online for more information at tusculum.edu or call 423-636-7300 and discover the Pioneer Experience for yourself.
The future holds even more promise with imaging at a molecular and cellular level on the horizon.
The Tusculum Experience is 20 sports, one team, striving for excellence. The Tusculum Experience offers state-of-the-art facilities for practice and game days. If you seek a championship atmosphere, the Tusculum Experience is for you. Visit online through TusculumPioneers.com. Call 423-636-7300 to discover the Pioneer Experience for yourself.
All the hard work and dedication had paid off, and you'd be so proud.
Is that how you feel when you build a custom tile shower?
It sure is. Sometimes I have to hold myself back from doing a touchdown dance.
For a great selection and expert installers, see my popsy at Terry's Floor.
You're listening to South Atlantic Conference Football on WSMG with Brian Staten and
Xavier Huey. Is the injured Hawk. He's down earlier in the game as well. He is walking off under his own power. It's third down and 9 for this Pioneer football team. Two wideouts, two backs in the backfield as Ogle will come under center. 4:14 to play. Trying to run a screen, and it's going to be incomplete. Would have been well read by the defense. The pass intended for Jordan Shippey. And Ogle, who took a hit after the play, will get up, have his shoulder pad fixed. It'll be fourth down, and we'll see Hunter Cantrell onto the into the game for the third time.
Yeah, not a lot of action for Hunter Cantrell tonight. Like to see him get an opportunity to get a good kick here as we get ready to head into South Atlantic Conference play next week in case he's needed.
He had a field position punt. Say that because he had the short field to go against, so he angled the ball down and beautiful punt that was inside the 10 at the 6, caught by D. Alford, then a 42-yard kick as well. O'Grady snaps it, and Cantrell gets away a very high, wobbly spiral. Fair catch will be asked for and caught at the 28-yard line, and that is where Shorter will take over, first and 10. So there you go. Good punt by Cantrell.
Updated scoring. Brian must have had a safety down at Limestone. Limestone now leads Benedict 9-7 at the start of the third quarter. Little Orion's up 19-7 over North Greenville at the half. North Carolina A&T has stretched its lead to 49-0 over Mars Hill in the fourth.
So at the 29 is where Shorter will take over. And we're still, I'm wondering, trying to figure out. Austin Fellows is the new quarterback. We've had that change, and I'm sure it was listed, and I wrote that down, and I, for some reason, have lost that piece of paper where I wrote that down coming to the game here today. So Fellows, maybe who has had his jersey changed, 9-10. Fellows, the quarterback out of Marietta, Georgia. He is also who scored. Lewis has been given credit for the touchdown, unless Fellows fumbled it and it was recovered by Lewis. It sure looked as if it was Fellows that got into the end zone. Needless to say, we have a 33-12 score and a slow-moving second half. Fellows will turn around and hand it off, and there's just not much running room right now against this Pioneer defense, and that's Patrick McGee, this redshirt freshman from Harrison, Tennessee, out of Chattanooga Central, has made a couple of fine plays on that defensive line for Coach Jerry Odom.
Game being slowed here in the second half, just from a number of penalties, Brian. Whereas the two teams have combined for a dozen penalties, and it seems like most of those have been here in the second half.
432 yards of offense for Tusculum, 168 for Shorter. Fellows working from the gun. Back to pass. Looking, 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 and sacked. And Patrick McGee just can't be blocked right now. Back inside the 25 at the 23-yard line for a loss of six. And Patrick McGee with a big play, forcing a fourth down.
And no Jay Boyd going out to field this one. Evan Altizer is going to resume his position as the Pioneers punt returner.
So fourth down, 16. Hayes to punt it. Punt last time of 49 yards, no return. Altizer back in there. He'll field it at the 38. Breaking one tackle, but not the third tackle, and he'll be brought down at the 38-yard line where the Pioneers will take over. First and 10, and it will be a new quarterback into the football game, or is it? Well, I thought he was coming in, and I don't know. It will be. Coming in, Hunter Wisemore, a redshirt freshman out of St. Cloud, Florida. He'll check in. The reason we're not going to see Tommy Pistone is because he has a back issue, battling a bad back through practice this week. So we'll see Wisemore. He'll check in. The redshirt, again, out of St. Cloud, Florida. Tommy Brown is the running back. He'll get the carry, starting left, and he'll take it up to about the 40-yard line. Gain of about a yard, maybe a yard and a half, and it'll bring up second down as we close in on 2 minutes to play in the game.
You know, I'm usually pretty good on geography, but bringing in all these guys from Florida, I'm not sure where exactly all of those guys are from. We talk about Naples, and we talk about the Miami area and Vero Beach for Jay Boyd, but I don't know where St. Cloud is.
Well, just to be perfectly honest, a lot of the reason that a lot of people say, well, you know, Jerry sure likes those Florida guys. Well, it's where he's from. It's what he recruited when he was a coach in Jacksonville, so he still has those ties, and he still had kids that he was watching when they were sophomores and juniors, so he still has a lot of that. He'll build those relationships in this part of the country as well. Tommy Brown with the carry, breaks a tackle at the 40, 45, and up to the 50. He'll move the chains for a first and 10 for the Pioneers.
I don't blame him at all. I use those contacts. Florida, great high school football state. Even think back to the 1980s when the University of Miami first really popped on the scene. It's because they said, we're going to shut down lower Florida. There's no going to be any school recruiting here except the University of Miami, and then the Hurricanes became famous.
Yeah. And they sure did. Howard Schnellenberger, right? He's the guy that kind of was the architect of all of that.
And then followed up by Jimmy Johnson.
First down and 10 from midfield. Brown with another carry. He'll run left. Daylight, 45. Brown breaks a tackle at the 42 and takes it down to the 40-yard line. And it'll be another first and 10 for the Pioneers on a pickup of 11.
Good pickup there for the Pioneers. 1 minute, 2 seconds on the clock. It's now running, and we're under a minute here for a first victory of the season for the Pioneers.
Tusculum leading at 33-12. And again, 33 points back-to-back games. This is a team that did not average double digits until week six last year.
Big turnaround for the Pioneers, and big things on the horizon, I hope.
Three wideouts. Shaq Harris tied in to the right. Brown lines up behind Wisemore with 35 seconds to play. He'll back up into the gun. 5 seconds to get the play off. Snap. Wisemore to pass. It will be in. It's caught. 30, 20, 10, 5. House. Touchdown, Pioneers. Touchdown, Keandre Banks from Wisemore. And the Pioneers had a little extra firework here at the end of the game.
I honestly believe that ball was tipped into his hands, and because I was looking to see if it hit the ground. One of the defensive backs was angry with himself because he thought he had the interception, and the next thing you know, Pioneers are streaking into the end zone.
Unbelievable. Banks has made two quality plays on offense in back-to-back weeks. Touchdown last week against North Greenville. Touchdown here tonight. And in probable way, it looked as if the pass was – I didn't see Banks in the picture for a second. I saw the defensive back, but it looks as if Keandre Banks has just kind of come out and I'll have to look at it again, but almost as if he just reaches out with one hand and pulls it in after maybe the defensive back got a hand on it first. Gallegos to attempt. Snap, hold, kick. No good. Uh-oh.
Marred his perfect night in his Pioneer debut.
Uh-oh. We missed three extra points on the year. They'll probably, there might be another competition this week. Let's go to a break. Return 20 seconds to play in the game. Your new score, it's Tusculum 39 and Shorter 12. Pioneer football continues here from Pioneer Field on the Pioneer Sports Network.
The first date. Only one chance to make that first impression. Don't worry. This might be new for you, but Ingles has been there before. From flowers to the freshest ingredients, we have everything you need to put your best foot forward.
I'm sorry.
Remember, you can't get to happily ever after without once upon a time. Ingles, all the ingredients for family.
Well, Keandre Banks is making a name for himself for the Pioneers. A 39-yard pass from Hunter Wisemore. The Isaac Gallegos kick, no good. That is your Terry's Flooring scoring recap. Bailey fields it at the 2-yard line after the kickoff by Schillings and will go down across the 20 at the 22-yard line with 14.8 seconds to play in this football game. That's a big open field tackle that was made on special teams by Isaiah Dunn, a junior out of McDonough, Georgia.
Right here, Shorter has maybe time for two plays to get a shot downfield. Pioneers drop back in to prevent coverage just so you don't give up a touchdown, because the more they're running around in the middle of the field, it's just going to run time off the clock.
Shorter in back-to-back weeks, basically against two South Atlantic Conference teams, have given up 40 points in each game. Today, the Pioneers score 39, Mars Hill 40 last week. Shorter's just going to take a knee.
That'll work, too. They're ready to go back to Georgia.
So the Shorter Hawks and the Tusculum Pioneers play the first ever meeting between these two schools, and the Pioneers come away with the win against this Shorter Hawks team. Tusculum grounding the Hawks in their first meeting. Jerry Odom evens his record here on the season to 1-1 as they knock off Shorter by a final score of 39-12. Orange Wave Night, very effective. A defense that came to play, limiting the Shorter offense to less than 200 yards of total offense in this game. And the offense goes over 400 yards, putting up 39 points in the game. Pioneers victorious. Our Pioneer postgame coming up. First, it'll be Joe and I just breaking down the game, and then we'll have this little fireworks display, and then we'll go down to the field with Pioneer coach Jerry Odom and our Pioneer players of the game. That's when we continue with more. Again, your final score, Tusculum 39 and Shorter 12. Thanks for listening to Pioneer Football. Now stay tuned for your Pioneer postgame report here on the Pioneer Sports Network.
Hey, Alan, I heard that having your prescription filled at one of those big box stores, you're thinking of losing.
Work tirelessly for you and always keep your best interests at heart. Simply call 639-3465.
You would think.
Or Google Realty
Executives. We're ready, Nate.
East Tennessee Realtors of Greenville for our contact information and to read our 5-star reviews. Let Realty Executives guide you home.
The Pioneer Postgame Report, brought to you by Greenville Light and Power, Hometown Realty and Auction, Laughlin Memorial Hospital, Corley's Pharmacy, Gateway Ford Mazda, Quick Stop Markets, Realty Executives, Greenville Federal Bank, and Terry's Flooring. And now, Justin Jeffords and the voice of the Pioneers, Brian Staden.
And we welcome you back into the Pioneer Postgame Report, where the Tusculum Pioneers victorious tonight. Final score of 39-12. Just kind of give you some of the numbers here tonight. Pioneers 39-12. That's basically all the numbers that you really need. 39 points tonight for Coach Jerry Odom. They've scored 33 and 39 in back-to-back games. 27-12, the difference in first downs. Tusculum runs for 192. Shorter just 34 yards tonight. Tusculum throws for 297, Shorter 126. Not a great percentage night for Ogle, 17 of 32, but still he'll take it. 58 yards. Didn't have a touchdown, did throw the pick. Hunter Wisemore throws one pass. It was a touchdown to Keandre Banks of 39 yards. I can't wait to see that one again. Tyler Pullum, 12 of 19 tonight, 126 and a touchdown. Rushing tonight, Maxwell Joseph goes over 100 yards, 21 carries, 123 yards, and 3 touchdowns tonight. 4 touches for Jordan Shippey for 32 yards, 4 touches for Lorenzo Pratt for 20 yards, Tommy Brown 6 carries for 27 yards. It was Weldron Ford at 13 carries, 54 yards, only saw B.J. McCoy in the first quarter, 4 carries for 3 yards, and that was about it for him. Receiving, a lot of guys. We spread the wealth. Evan Altizer with 4 catches, 65 yards. Evan Gates, 4 catches, 59 yards. Rodnell Cruel, 3 catches, 46 yards. Shaq Harris, 3 catches, 32 yards. Keandre Banks, 2 catches, 40 yards and a score. Chavis Williams, 2 catches, 55 yards and a long of 43 tonight. Joseph Ross, the big receiver last week, didn't have that type of day. 2 catches, 46 yards. Lewis Hayes was the top target, 5 catches for 43 yards. In this football game, some of our numbers in this contest, your stats here tonight, this Tusculum football team, you don't need to talk about stats. They dominated this football game, time of possession, defense seemed to be flying, they seem to be rolling right now. Let's start there because Shorter came out, first possession, they moved the ball, but after that it was all Tusculum's defense.
Yeah, it's when we said, I said at the start of the game, hey, I want to see the Pioneers start the way they finished last week. Didn't exactly do that. It was a slow start for the defense. Gave up that first series for the to the Hawks. Didn't give up the points, really, but did give up some big yardage. But they corrected that, and ultimately a good game for the defense here.
It is a Pioneer team that offensively – what a stark contrast from one year to the next. And with so many new faces that are making plays, Altizer's your mainstay, but here's Maxwell Joseph, tough to bring down. Lorenzo Pratt, good to see him. He does have that burst of speed. But Alex Ogle just, he's like the arc. He's just the guy, he's just kind of back there and making sure that the train doesn't come off the tracks. And he did he did throw the pick, but I think he did a very nice job tonight.
Yeah, but also throw in the fact, how amazing is it he's still able to do that? He didn't have a touchdown pass tonight.
Yeah, yeah. Just the job that he does, what Brian Ferguson is calling, they're executing it. Kevion Broadwater was back. I thought that the offensive line, that was kind of my key. They have to have a better game. When you look down there and you see that you run for 192, you throw for 297, I think they had a pretty good game.
Oh, yeah, and that's just a matter of coming together. We always heard that a team improves the most from game one to game two. We saw game one last week. Offensive line didn't play particularly well. Played really well tonight. I hope they make a lot more improvements from game two to game three next week when we go to Limestone.
One sack tonight allowed by this Pioneer offensive line. Kevion Broadwater back in there at left tackle. That kind of solidified some things for them. Special teams, well, we've got a new name, a new guy, Isaac Gallegos. He did miss an extra point. You got to shore that up. But when you go 4-for-4 in field goals, and really just kind of thrown in there to the fire. We're just kind of learning him as he comes in. But that's a big game for a freshman.
It really is. And as I say, I saw him down there. I was standing near him on the field at halftime, and he come back out, young man, just grinning and thrilled to death to be coming out here making his Pioneer debut. And I can see him standing out there now. He's kind of looking up, and I think he's still smiling.
I would have that smile on my face as well. They had to take it two shorter, and we had big plays. We had that big play potential in this game tonight as well. A 25-yard run by Maxwell Joseph, 24 yards by Jordan Shippey. You had the big receptions tonight by Chavis Williams, Keandre Banks. Obviously, that one went for a touchdown. But the possession catches, Evan Altizer of 23, Evan Gates of 21, Rodnell Cruel of 20. Those three guys that I just mentioned all came back to help their quarterback out in some way when he was either on the move or just extending the play in some way to move the chains. We were great on third downs tonight. And I think that's just the efficiency of what I've seen about this offense. Joseph pounding it. You got to respect that. And it gives Ogle the time to find an open receiver.
It really does. And you mentioned those long runs. Those are great. Those are exciting. But even the best of teams, they're few and far between. It's what your bread and butter is, are those short runs. In the past with the Pioneers, if they needed a short run, it was just kind of like, oh, well.
Who do we give it to?
Coin flip at best if we're not going to get it. Now I feel that the majority of the time, may not get every one if they need to pick up 2 or 3 yards in a down situation. But now I certainly like the opportunity that they're going to convert more than they're not.
I've noticed about shorter, they got a little ways to go. And I think it's their offensive line as well. They're big guys. But we saw the speed of a Pioneer defense. You know, we kept calling tonight the name of a guy I won't forget, Richard Gervell, another guy, George Lira, Lakeith Brown. The speed of those three really disrupted what the offense was doing tonight.
Well, whenever you have that threat, a fast defense is going to disrupt an offense, because not only are you trying to concentrate offensively on completing your assignment and your play, you're having to do it under duress.
Yeah, and it just seemed like Pullum was taken off the spot a bunch. So let's get into what's going on next week for this Pioneer team. We open up conference play. Conference Alliance member Limestone, the Saints, will host the Pioneers from the reservation in Gaffney, South Carolina. They opened up with ETSU. They're playing Benedict tonight. And that's a tight game there.
That is 7-7. I said 9-7 earlier, but I think it was just the way I looked at the score. It is Limestone 7, Benedict 7. That is in the third quarter, Brian.
You know, and this is a Limestone team, and I think it's a product of just didn't have enough quarterbacks returning to the South Atlantic Conference this year, that from 1 year to the next. So your preseason all-conference quarterback is Ivan Corbin from Limestone, a first-team preseason all-conference pick, and he didn't have a tremendous year, but that just shows you the respect about what the other coaches think about what's coming back this year.
It really is. I mean, and all that stuff is great to post on your refrigerator and your I Love Me wall, but let's be honest, a preseason football player, all-conference football player, that's about as important as who leads the first lap in a race.
It's very true. It's just noteworthy. Limestone,
yeah.
It's not a team that we can look over, I don't think, because here's a team that, you know, they've got the facilities where they've got the reservation. It's a 20,000-seat facility.
And that's actually a high school stadium. It does not belong to Limestone. They play at Gaffney High School, because when it's right down the road from your college, you don't need to build a stadium.
You don't need to build. You've already got a monstrosity right there in your backyard. So Limestone is our opponent next week. Like to see this team make some more improvement. Did you see anything we still need, you think, to improve into next week?
Offensive line still needs to continue to be solid up front, get a little bit better each time out. There's always room for improvement. I don't care if we had a 99-12 tonight. There's always room for improvement. And this Pioneer team, I think they've got the capability. They've got the players willing to learn, wanting to learn, wanting to succeed, and they've got the coaching staff that's able to teach them and get them in that direction.
Thank you, sir.
Glad to be here.
We will wrap it up from the field when our Pioneer postgame coverage continues. Still to come, we'll have some scores from around the South Atlantic Conference, and we will bring you Jerry Odom and our player of the game. That's when we continue with more of our Pioneer postgame report. He is Joe Bird. Your final score, Tusculum 39 and Shorter 12. Pioneer football continues on the Pioneer Sports Network. All right, Nate, I'll try to get down there quickly.
And as always, we ask that you please drive home safely.
Stop into your neighborhood.
The Tusculum Experience is 20 sports, one team, striving for excellence. The Tusculum Experience offers state-of-the-art facilities for practice and game days. If you seek a championship atmosphere, the Tusculum Experience is for you. Visit online through TusculumPioneers.com. Call 423-636-7300 to discover the Pioneer Experience for yourself.
College 39 and Shorter 12. Two games still in progress in the conference. In the third quarter, it is Lenore Ryan leading North Greenville by a score of 19-7. And Limestone is in a tie in their game against Benedict. The score there in the second quarter is knotted up at 7 apiece for Limestone and Benedict. More to come from the post-game show from the Pioneer Sports Network in just a bit.
Hometown Realty of Greenville is selling Greenville and Greene County one yard at a time. Every coach knows making the right call is what makes his team successful. If you want success in moving your real estate, get the home field advantage.
Yeah, make check. Sure to make I'm checking right. See if you got me.
Gotcha. You ready for something?
It's up to you. You want to go right? I don't have you. Hold on.
Can you hear me?
I think I hear you.
I'm ready when you are.
Okay, I got you.
Are you ready with anything yet?
Not just yet. Let me get the camera guy hooked up. Let's get a little bit closer here. Yeah.
All you have to do is loosen the laser.
Hey, nice shot. Oh, the feed isn't real loud. No, I think I turned it down. That's my problem.
So you're just ready right now?
We're ready. You good? All right,
I'll
give you a countdown.
I didn't think you were ready yet.
I know, I'm not ready. I'm just waiting for them to get the camera set up. So you just tell me when and I'll go.
Okay. So I don't need to fill any more time?
Tell me again.
I don't need to fill any more time. That's what I'm waiting for.
No, you don't need to at this time. me. I'm with Joe.
Okay, I'll just give you a go.
All right, you ready? Just start rolling. We'll start it. I'm just waiting to hear.
Okay.
It's live. It's live stuff, you know.
Yeah.
Stand by.
I'm good.
5 seconds.
Welcome back in. Pioneer post-game report. The Pioneers have knocked off the Shorter Hawks in the school's first ever meeting, a final of 39-12. Joined by Pioneer coach Jerry Odom, whose team, when you look at the numbers, it's going to look about like it should have, I think, tonight. The scoreboard, I think you guys came out. After their first series, did you just have to kind of get a feel of what they were doing offensively?
Well, I mean, we just didn't get off the field on third down. They converted two third downs on us where they made a play, and one time we busted a little thing, and then we settled down. And I think after that, they were 2-15 or something like that after that. So, you know, I felt like offensively we moved it, but we left too many points out there. I mean, I'm happy that Isaac kicked four field goals, but I'd rather score two more touchdowns, you know, in that situation. So we'll work hard on the red zone stuff and, you know, get going on that. Obviously, defensively, I hated to give up 12 points. You know, that last one kind of stunk, but, you know, and we kind of had a lull. We put some young guys in there right before the half, and they had a little bit of a lull. And we got to learn to finish halves, you know, and I think that's the word of the day is finish. So I think we played okay, but I think there's a lot of things we can do better.
I think it's funny how you say I put some young guys in there. You're full of young guys. There's no question. And some of those guys showed a lot of speed tonight. You guys just look really a lot faster than they did.
Yeah, I think we were. I mean, they were big, but I knew they were going to struggle with our speed up front. You know, when you've got, you know, George Lear and Richard Gravel are both, you know, George ran 10-4-8. Wicker ran 10-4-8 and George ran 10-9 last year in the 100. Those guys can really run, and then when you add in, you know, like Lakeith and Ivan Hogan's and those guys, now we got some dudes who can get out there and get after it. So we'll keep on working, you know, to shore up the things we didn't do right. And, you know, we're going to have to. We play Limestone next week, and then, you know, we got UNC Pembroke. I told them the goal has got to be try to get to, you know, undefeated. You know, we lost that first one. We got to try to win the rest of them to have a chance going into our conference schedule to hopefully make the playoffs.
It was an offense tonight that really got going your running game. This guy that's going to talk to, Maxwell Joseph, he really allowed Ogle some time back there. Clean sheet. Good to see Kevion Broadwater back. I think that shored up the offensive line. A lot of things tonight in the offense looked really, really crisp.
Yeah, I think when you have almost 500 yards offense, you know, that's never a bad thing. And I think we had balance, which is what we talked about. Brian did a good job calling it, but I thought we were in the outside zone. Well, I thought Maxwell makes some really nice cuts. He's got to learn to run lower in his pads and not so high. If he'll do that, then he'll really run well and, you know, and hold on to the ball down near the end zone, that kind of stuff. But other than that, he played good. I'm just kind of messing around with him.
Yeah, it's because he's standing right over here next to us. He's within earshot. But I think, impressed with just the way these wide receivers run routes, the offensive line giving Ogle the time to pass it. You know, I think he's upset he let that one get away. He doesn't have the touchdown tonight, but, man, he's just really good numbers.
Well, I mean, the bottom line is he's a pretty good football player, and we just got to, you know, he's – the only thing sometimes Alex does is he presses, you know, and he's got to learn to keep driving the bus. Just take what they give you. Don't try to get the big play. And a couple of them really weren't his fault. We had one pick. The depth of the receiver was wrong. We were supposed to have a post dig, and it almost looked like double digs. We had a couple young guys in there, and there was just too much traffic in there. So, yeah, he probably shouldn't throw it. He should have taken the guy in the flat, but it wasn't all his fault on that.
And we meet Isaac Gallegos tonight as well. Must have been a pretty good competition this week in practice. And he comes in and gets 4-for-4 field goals.
Yeah, he kicked well this week in practice. And I just basically said whoever kicks the best is going to get the shot. And, you know, he hit the ball well. I mean, you know, both our young kickers kicked well. Our kickoff guy was great, kicked a bunch out of the end zone. And, you know, I really, you know, I think Gabe's getting better at that. And they're both freshmen, so we'll just keep on keeping on.
And I think you showed good style of football tonight to the community. You know, a good atmosphere here tonight. Good win, big win. Limestone is next. Yeah. We're on the road for the next 2 weeks. Don't forget about what we just saw here tonight. But Limestone presents a somewhat of a problem because they've got some guys back on offense that have been there, some veterans.
Yeah, they do. But, you know, looking at them last week, I took a quick peek at them last week. They ran the ball solid last week against ETA. They couldn't throw 29 yards passing. I think the quarterback's a little better than that. Each had a nice scheme against them, but it'll be a tough game. I mean, you know, that could, just do a good job. We're going on the road again. We just got to, you know, we'll have to heal up. We're beat up a little bit. You know how that all goes, and heal up, and we'll have to get better, you know, this week and keep on working.
Hey, good win tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Pioneer coach Jerry Odom, the Pioneers knock off the Shorter Hawks in the school's first ever meeting. The Pioneers get their second win all time against the Gulf South Conference. We're back with more right after this on the Pioneer Sports Network.
I think that most of us would agree that fall is the best time of the year. I love it when the air cools down, the leaves start to change, and football season is here. From grade school to college, it's a great time for families and communities to come together to cheer on the favorite team. This is Alan Johnson from Marathon Quick, wishing each player out there a great season. Give it 110%. These are some of the best times of your life. Marathon Quick Stop, run in when you run out.
You know, the only thing
did
I
you
like
know
about
that by
thing,
simply
Donald?
Downloading the new Greenville Light and Power System smart app to your mobile device and tablet, you have the freedom to pay your bills, use the payment history, view your usage history, receive email or text alerts, and report outages.
I'm freezing.
For more information on this simple way of managing your electric account, contact Greenville Light and Power System at 636-6200 or go online and click on the Smart Hub icon.
Advances in medical imaging technology allow our doctors to detect, diagnose, and treat disease earlier and more accurately with less invasive.
All right, we're ready, Nate, after this. Just tell me what I got. I can hear it now.
Make it possible for a doctor to
I'll take it after this one. And we welcome you back into the Pioneer Sports Network and our Pioneer postgame coverage. The Pioneers have knocked off the Shorter Hawks tonight, 39-12. Pioneers 33 and 39 points in their first two games of the year. This is a team last year, I don't know if you knew this, didn't average double digits in offense until week six of the year. So this Pioneer offense is rolling. Big reason why the guy standing right here, Maxwell Joseph, tonight, big game. 21 carries, 123 yards, three scores tonight. Maxwell, let's talk about this offense getting going, because it seems as if we mixed in the big play with the passing game because you were able to loosen up their defense a little bit. How were you able to do that? Was your offensive line just that good tonight?
Yeah, it's all about my offensive line. All of them boys, they've been working hard in practice. I've been finding the holes. It's just all of them. They've been grinding the whole week. So, like, I knew it was gonna be. I was going to have a big game. Yeah. So, like, I give all respect to my offensive line. I love them boys.
All right, let's talk about your longest run of the year, 25-yarder that you had into the end zone. What did you see there on that particular touchdown? It seems as if it was a cutback. Was the hole that big? Because it looked pretty big from up on top of the booth.
Like what I saw, like the whole week, we were looking up for cutbacks because like our defense always like over pursues. So like when I did, it was six. So when I ran the play, I saw the nose tackle. Oh yeah, like, he over pursued, cut back. I think I stiffed-armed some dude, and it was just wide open. I just ran.
This is a good night for this offense. I think you guys needed this. You showed your speed, not only offensively but also defensively. But did you guys feel as if you were that much faster than this team?
Yeah, during the week, like when I was watching film on them, I knew we were a lot better than this team. Like we should have put up, we left a lot of points on the field. We should have put more. But like during the week, I was just like, wow, like this team. I'm not gonna say they suck, but like they were not as good as they. I thought they were trying to make it feel so.
You know, it got physical, and I think when it got physical in the football game, it made you guys a little bit better. Did you feel the tide change a little bit when you? I'm not even gonna say it was chippy. You got that chip on your shoulder, but I just think when it got physical, you guys got better. Did you sense that?
Yeah, like when a game gets physical, that's what I love because I'm a downhill running back. So like once a game gets physical, that's what I like. I like guys coming trying to hit me, and I'm a. With me, I like to attack the defense more to hit me. That's why every time I run hard. So, like, when the game gets physical, that's what I love. I love it when the game gets physical.
You know, I know I'm going to go talk with Coach Ferguson this week and we'll say, you know, how did the offense respond? Were they as good as it looked like? What did you think? Did you guys execute the game plan almost to perfection tonight or at least as close as you guys could get?
I won't say we executed perfectly because, like I said, we left a lot of points in the red zone. Like, I shouldn't – like, there was a play with down to here when, like, I was running the ball and I fumbled. And, like, I shouldn't be doing that right there. So, we left a lot of plays on the field, a lot of plays open. We should – the score shouldn't be 39-12. It should have been a lot more than that.
Do you feel this offense is executing at a high level, though?
Yes, because North Greenville, when we played North Greenville, we made a lot of mental mistakes in the second half. So this whole week, we just try to fix those mistakes, and pass blocking and everything. So this week, I think we got better. So hopefully next week, we can keep doing the same thing, keep going week by week.
Sounds like what you're saying is you guys got to be better in the red zone, and this offense might be as complete. Limestone going to present a good challenge for you guys, another night games back in South Carolina. I want to ask you, how's the family? Have you had a chance to talk with them, and how are they doing down there in Florida?
My mom, she's in I think, Sarasota, Florida.
Yeah.
Because she works and helps old people because she's like a nurse. She helps them, so she's in Sarasota, Florida right now. My dad, and my two brothers, I think they're in a hotel somewhere in, I think, Pensacola, Florida. So, like, they're still in Florida, so I'm just sending prayers to them. Hopefully, right. I'll send prayers to them and help them. I just hope that storm doesn't get too bad because I love Naples. Naples is a beautiful place.
Yeah. Hey, we're thinking about you. Thank you. It's a great game. Congratulations.
Appreciate it.
That's Maxwell Joseph. Pioneers knock off the Shorter Hawks tonight, 39-12. Back with more of our Pioneer postgame after this on the Pioneer Sports Network.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir. Hey, man. How are you?
Popsy, I need to ask.